What's up, Twitch community? We see your comments here coming in. What's up, Vice? What's up, YouTube? What's up, Waypoint? What's up, internet at large? You're here in the boat party living room. The last time you saw us, we were finishing the boat on the Waypoint live stream launch, 72 hours.
Yeah.
I'm joined with Jason.
I'm joined by Dan.
Jason's joined by me. And we're here to show you basically the progress of the boat and play some games on it in its unfinished state.
Do you want to give these guys the shot of the boat here?
Yeah, let's see the boat real quick.
It's looking.
We have it here in the living room. We have the LEDs just kind of draped all over the place. The top of the boat is not on. We have some work to do on it to completely finish it, but we wanted to save that.
Well, if any of you saw the promo for the boat party, you got to see part of what we did with it, which was sawing off the...
Yeah, we have to do some customizing stuff. But tonight is not going to be exactly about building or manufacturing or customizing the case.
Right.
We're kind of just playing it as is, nuts and bolts.
And when we're sitting here talking, is there like some jazz playing for the audience?
I don't know if there's music playing. Audience, if you want to hear some kind of back... Well, we're going to jump into some games, and then you're going to hear some music.
They can put on their own background.
Yeah, and you should be listening to your own music.
Yeah,
we have a Seinfeld Costanza thing going.
I like
apparently.
That.
Well, there. Oh, I'm probably Costanza. Fuck.
What did that guy in the YouTube comments say?
He said this show kind of feels like a couple of sitcom about a couple of wacky dads, except for raising a kid. It's about raising a gaming PC built in a boat. So anyways, tonight, what we're going to do is... I mean, there's a lot of kind of background to this, but what we're going to do is we're going to play some of our favorite games that we think are the sort of the top of the line games that you can get right now on Steam. And we've been benchmarking the computer based on them, and we've kind of fallen in love with a few of them. We're just going to watch Jason play. I'm going to play some games, and we're also going to play some other games that are just sort of we find interesting.
Oh, are we going to address the presence of the third dude who is as of yet unacknowledged? Our bartender, Virgil.
Yep, and so for every episode of this, we're gonna have a different bartender, or maybe the same, depending on what you guys think. No matter what, the bartender's name is gonna be Virgil.
This is always Virgil. We actually are only picking bartenders that are named Virgil to make sure that we always have a legit Virgil in the room.
Yeah.
So he's gonna actually, tonight's cocktail, what's tonight's cocktail?
The Hemingway Daiquiri.
We thought that was boat appropriate.
Yeah, we're gonna do boat-themed drinks. A boat-appropriate drink.
What goes in that?
Well, we're gonna do. There's gonna be a standalone video that explains the drink that we're making that you're gonna be able to watch later this week.
That's nice that we're doing that.
Yeah, because I don't want to hear about it right now.
Gamers like making high-end cocktails.
They do now.
This is new.
Yeah, I mean, this is the thing. Making high-end cocktails is just as hard as playing Witcher 3.
Yeah.
As I've learned.
For you.
It's like putting spells on a sword, except it's like putting a spell in a cup.
It's putting a spell in a cup.
Yeah.
Why don't you put a spell in a cup for one of us right now? That'd be nice.
Sounds good.
Well, yeah. So while we're doing this, what we wanted to do is we wanted to stream to you guys in 4K.
But this is your camera.
That's me. I just look anywhere? Because they're all over the fucking place.
Yeah, they are kind of all over the place.
Oh, wait. So we have a swear jar.
Yeah, it's
we're trying
true.
To keep it clean for the most part. I don't have any.
Where's the change? We want to punish ourselves for swearing. So we have a swear jar here.
The swear jar is, you know.
And if you guys want to hit the tip jar on Twitch every time we hit the swear jar, that'll help us recoup our money that we're spending so that we can swear to you.
Do we have
maybe
a tip
not.
Jar thing for Twitch?
I don't really care right now.
Well, either way, so we wanted to do 4K. We've been fighting with the hardware for this for two solid days now. We've settled on a 1080p stream. And at the end of this, we're going to upload some benchmarks in 4K. I'm also going to run 3D Mark, and I'm going to upload our scores so you can all mock them
now
or
what
appreciate them.
What is 3D Mark? Oh, wait, yeah. Let's talk about resolution for a minute. So and because this is a show about gaming and technology, we're going to talk about resolution. The stream that you guys are watching is 720. That's because our Ethernet connection here at the house is not very good.
It is really good.
Well, it is good, but
something's
not,
fucked up.
It's not good enough.
Something's just wrong.
And the state of broadcast technology that's affordable is not going to allow us to play games for you in 4K. So we're playing tonight in 1080. You guys are seeing it in 720. But just to prove to you and to show to you that you can build a 4K capable computer for not an extreme amount of money,
right.
We're going to do some benchmarks and show you guys that you can do a lot of this at 4K. And we'll show you the benchmarks at the end. But and for now, we're just going to play some games.
We're just going to play games and enjoy ourselves.
That's pretty good.
There it is.
I hope you guys are drinking reasonably and
responsibly.
Responsibly,
that's
because we're going to have a few. It's Sunday night. Tomorrow's a holiday.
This guy said, he said a reasonable amount of money. He says, isn't that boat like $1,000? The boat case was actually a lot of money, but...
It's an aspirational build.
You could put it in whatever you want.
Yeah. I mean, we spent $500 on the case.
Leon Lee really... I think they're watching.
I don't know if the people from Leon Lee who made the case are watching, but if they are, what are we going to say to them? Nothing, because we're going to keep talking. Hey,
oh,
Jason, I want to watch you play some games.
Okay. Let me just get this, baby.
Hey, why don't we give these to our technical director? There's two people behind the scenes. Their names are Turtle and Denny. And we're going to give them drinks because they've been working hard for the last 3 days to get this up and running.
Okay, so what do you want to start with? I think we should start just with the classic. We'll go with Doom.
Yeah, so one of the games that I've found the most interesting since we've had this machine at the house is Doom.
Damn,
2016. This was the game that I pretty much... So I quit gaming about 15 years ago.
What does it mean if somebody has a crown next to their name on Twitch?
I don't know. Twitch, what does it mean if there's a crown?
Hey guys, what's a crown mean?
Let us know. We're reading your comments. We have it on a TV at the bottom.
Yeah. Also, you know, you guys are the third host of the show, Twitch. Twitch is in the room.
Yeah.
You guys are here.
Yeah, we're going to be talking
we're
to you
reading
guys.
Your stuff. We're talking to you, so say what you want to say. All right, go ahead.
So we're going to play Doom. Because I like it. I think it looks great. It's really fun. And I've been watching Jason play it for a while. And it's nasty.
Oh, crown means prime. That means they're paying for their Twitch.
Oh, well.
That means they're paying for to see this. Well.
That's fine.
I don't like this guy. Tell me I have old man reaction time. I'm going to show him right now.
You have old man reaction time in reference to what?
I'm playing this game. I've been crushing this game.
He thinks you're slow at this game?
Matter of fact, I'm going to crank it up. Hold on.
You're going to play it at what mode?
What's Bloodfall? What is this? I don't care about
Bloodfall
it.
Bloodfall is a download.
Let's do a new slot. Fresh.
Sure. Oh, I like where you left off, though. Oh, but are we in my account or yours?
We're in your account. It's a little bit easy for somebody of my skill level.
Okay.
And I would like to... Hurt me plenty. See, this is the thing. I'm using a controller.
Uh-huh.
We all know that controllers are, I'm going to say this.
Who's we all? Because I don't know.
Using a controller is a major hindrance in an FPS game.
In an FPS is first person shooter.
Yeah. So even though I want to crank it all the way up, I could do that with a mouse, but I'm going to do it with a controller. I'm going to show people that I'm capable of doing this.
Oh, because you're like kind of like
a show off.
You're like a show off kind of guy.
When I my audio weird? Hold on a minute. How's that?
We'll see. We got a microphone problem here with Jason, but
I'm just gonna lay it
right
in the couch
here. It's
just
one of his problems. Oh, see, look, they're already making fun of you for pretending to be special.
Let's turn off the tutorials.
I think a beard is hitting the mic.
Your beard? No, it's not. I said that earlier.
Denny says it's not a beard.
Oh,
swear jar.
Let me just pull this out because I brought this because I think I'd be swearing a lot.
That's Jason's, put it on the
shit.
Table. That's two.
Damn.
That's four.
Hold on. All right. So this is mine. Don't take any of these.
I need to buy some from you because I need to swear.
What do you got?
I don't know. I'll buy, I'll start with $3 worth of coin.
I'm going to give you dollar coins.
This is kind of like when you're in an RPG and you get to like the trading post.
Do you have a single?
I have three singles.
Okay, fine, hold on.
I'm gonna buy $3 worth of swears from you.
Here's $1 of swears. And this is Canadian. Just take it.
If we did nickels, then I could swear more.
The swear jar accepts everything. Here you go.
Can I swear five times per quarter?
No. It's a coin.
Ugh. These are going to be expensive swears, guys.
Some people only have dollar coins that we're going to have on the show tonight.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, and if you guys get really bored, let us know, because we have some special guests that we're keeping in the other room.
Yeah, we're making them wait until we get boring, which shouldn't take long.
Yeah, we got this guy named Mark who's sitting cross-legged in the hallway.
Is he out there?
No, but I mean, he's not actually doing that, but we're pretending he is.
Don't let him in here until I say so. Look smoothing. This setting, look smoothing, is so bad. Anything besides zero is a complete disaster.
What does look smoothing do?
It's supposed to help you aim without having... It just smooths out the motion, but what it really does is make your reaction time terrible. It just kind of like... The acceleration and deceleration of moving is just an absolute disaster.
Okay.
All right, mouse keyboard. So I think we're good. Let's crank them everything up. That's all up.
Subtitles.
Video. As you can see...
We need to rescan Jason's mic.
What do you mean rescan?
All right, so grab it off of him and do it while he's playing.
There you go.
Also, guys, for those of you tuning in, we are doing this pretty much DIY with no budget, and we don't have a sound operator. We don't have much here besides cameras.
Can they hear me on that?
They can hear you if you, yeah.
Set subtitles to max. You got it.
What's that going to do?
I want to max it out.
Wait, how many options are there for subtitles? Is it just off and on?
Maxed out.
So max would be on.
It's on.
That's pretty good.
All right, new campaign. I'm doing it. So, let's
Knick-knack.
Do it. Right, you can see, we're at a nice 60 frames. That's because we're playing in 1080p. Let's not fool ourselves here. We have a GTX 1080. We're not optimizing anything.
What's a GTX 1080?
That's our card that we put in there.
What's a card? I'm asking you these questions because I didn't know this at the beginning. And
our video card is a GTX, the big one that you had to cram in there.
Right.
That you ripped all it's like $700 card that you use pliers to rip the LEDs off.
Right.
That's the card.
Okay, so that's a GPU.
It's big.
Well, that's what it's called, a GPU.
That's what it's called.
Graphics processing unit. And ours is a GTX 1080.
Dan's learning a lot of.
And I knew nothing about any of this up until about 4 months ago.
I like how this game starts and gives you zero indication you're going to be playing in about a second.
Are you playing now?
But it's so fast. As soon as you're out. And it's so shocking because it's so clean. It's amazing.
You can walk through. Hey, this guys, we have another character here.
He's trying to sneak in.
His name is Freak Show. And he's also running technicals along with Denny and Turtle. So again, write that down. It's Denny, Freak Show, and Turtle. They're running technicals for us. Denny's kind of got, you guys aren't going to see him. He's kind of got like a rat face with like a little pig snout. We can't put him on camera because it's so filthy and disgusting. And Freak Show, you might be able to see him right now. He's a very handsome young boy.
I don't really remember how to get past the beginning part here as quickly as possible.
Well, people are watching you.
Oh,
so
I remember. I have to go to the suit.
Yeah, get that thing on.
The depth of field in this makes it feel like
3D. I remember when we first fired this up, we both gasped.
Depth of field I've ever seen.
I mean, look at that. And Virgil, you've never seen this.
Never.
You haven't seen this before. Is this not crazy?
It's amazing.
You guys might notice that I'm playing in a window, and that's because our capture software, you're not going to believe this. We talk about the Forza incident?
We'll talk about Forza later.
We had an incident with some UWS insanity.
What's UWS?
Universal Windows Store? Platform?
Okay.
UWP? What is it, guys? Whatever the BS.
When you buy from Windows. Yeah. We bought a game called Forza Horizon 3.
That's it.
And it's another game we've been playing a lot because it really pushes the limits of the boat. And it really screwed up our whole broadcast setup. We have this machine here, it's called a TriCaster. And we were playing every game that we have, and as soon as we fired up Horizon, it broke everything we had. That was like 3 hours ago.
We can no longer plug any device into that unit. Oh, I should have used the thing on that guy.
What's the thing?
We need this.
Oh, that's a glory kill?
It is. Dan's learned a lot. And since we built this boat to today, I don't think Dan's left his room more than 6 times.
I go to work sometimes.
Besides work, I mean, he's really taken to this subculture.
Well, but see, here's the thing. I don't really play a lot of games. I actually watch more.
Have I not sworn since the last time I put money in?
No.
That's pretty good.
Yeah. What are we gonna do with the money from the swear jar?
What do you think? Hey, can you?
We should probably donate it to like
charity.
Yeah, but which charity?
What's
ooh. Thank you, Virgil.
Don't spill that on my
hand. That'd be funny though.
For the audience, not
I gotta
this is like a bunch of scum sucks.
I would call those scum freaks.
It's a room of pathetic. It's one of these that's just here to have you're supposed to have fun with.
I mean this is
I
the first
a barrel in this room you could do fun things with. They're all just dying on their own.
Well, it's probably because they're half dead to begin
they're
with.
Touching each other and just falling.
And
apart.
Where are you're in space?
I'm in Mars.
You're in Mars.
The original Doom games were on a Mars moon.
A Mars moon.
Phobos. And that was fun. I like being on a moon because it's interesting. Mars seems a little bit, I don't know, it's less creative to this game.
You know what I think is funny about Mars, the planet in real life?
What do you think is funny about it?
It's completely inhabited by robots. And it's our fault.
So it's a robotic society.
Yeah. Like if somebody else went to Mars, they'd be like, oh, there's like three robots
it's
here.
A robot planet.
And then they'd be like, I wonder how that happened. And then they'd be like, oh, it's the humans did it. Isn't that fucked up?
Are you guys, is anybody at home surprised by my level of skill right now?
I said. I stopped myself.
Oh, okay.
I got half a
I think a half swear is a swear still. Because everyone knows what you were going to say. You've made your point.
Hey, can you tell me why you jump so much in this game?
It's just part of the gig, man.
Do people like jumping in games?
Nobody really. Yeah, actually, yeah.
Why?
You like jumping in Mario.
I don't like jumping in real life.
You know what game was the worst to jump in? Was, the fuck, what was that?
Oh, God. Oh, you're playing like a spam.
Like a what?
A spaz.
A spaz? Who said that? Was it Petcause?
Hey, will these pro cameras be used for Waypoint streams going forward?
That's just for boat boys.
We're gonna have to send that one to the general manager of Waypoint. Jason's playing correctly, Ben says.
Thanks, Ben.
You're a real sweetheart.
You know,
you have to play Doom like you're actually on fire. I believe that. I mean, that
you
is.
You can't stop moving.
Yeah.
You're running and jumping constantly, yeah, which is what you're not supposed to do when you're on fire, really. Is
oh,
jump,
yeah, you
jump
just
stop,
drop, and
yeah, I think I did it.
Stop, drop, and roll.
Where's, oh, there's
oh,
one
there's
left.
A freak show. Well, that's freak show down there.
Oh,
but that's,
come on.
Oh, this is gross. Why are they all up in
all right. I'm healthy. The room's cleared. This is how you play Doom, people. And this is how you do it with the controller. I would rather be bad.
Let's say we're going to play Doom for another 20 minutes.
20 minutes?
Yeah, I think so.
We have to make time for you to show how good you've gotten at The Witcher 3.
But I'm in a place in that game that is not very good. I got, like, I lost track of my where I was. All right, so we're going to get to this, but the game I chose to play with my return to gaming after 15 years was Witcher 3. And Jason thinks that's funny because I basically took 15 years off gaming and came right back and have maybe what might be the best video game of all time.
On the best video card.
On one of the best video cards of all time. On one of the best TVs you could possibly get.
Yeah, your resurgence.
And so,
into
but
the
I've been
world.
Playing Witcher 3.
That's all intro?
That's the intro.
I forgot about
because these guys know how to do a good game.
They really do.
So I've been playing Witcher 3, and what I did was I played it for about 6 hours.
Do 100% speed clear.
Got really upset, and then kind of quit. And then one night, I had a lot of time to kill, and I cranked it up, and I was on Jason's sister's game.
Oh, yeah, you were.
And I ended up on level 16.
That's one of our guests is calling Dan.
Yep. Oh, we have a guest here. I'm going to let them in. So, Jason, you play this game and talk to them about this for a while.
You're not just going to throw the keys out the window like you do for everybody else?
Hello, Charlotte.
This is a special guest.
Hi.
Well, it's just me and Virgil now. How's it going back
there?
That's
okay. I'm gonna send somebody down.
Would you guys be interested in, how about we just let Dan
okay.
do his thing, and I just play through this game start to finish all the way. Can I go down there?
You feel
it?
Will you go get Charlotte?
Oh, yeah. I'll just do this by myself. Because honestly, Dan's really, if we're talking about who's the crux of this show, while he's out of the room, let's be serious. I mean, the guy can't play anything. You're going to see when he throws The Witcher on later. But he has gotten a lot better. He's improved significantly. What I was saying before was I would rather play Doom and be bad at it and use the controller and sit on a couch and have a beer and relax than be really good at it and use my mouse and keyboard and sit at my desk. I don't really care about... If I can still beat the game, if I'm still capable of beating it on a difficult setting without... Oh, shit. Can you throw a coin in the... As long as I can get through it, that's fine with me. I always prefer to go controller. And I wasn't always that way. I used to be a hardcore PC guy, but these days I just want. I'm talking to the community. I'm kind of. Oh no!
What happened?
Nothing.
What do you mean? Did you die?
You distracted me.
I distracted you.
But yeah, I like relaxing. Is Charlotte here?
Yeah. Freak Show just went to get her.
How come you left the room if he was going to get her?
I had to use the restroom.
So listen, I just died, and it was an embarrassment in front of the whole Twitch
community.
That's
really bad, Jason. You can't be dying if you think you're
and it's like
hot
level
stuff.
It's like level one too.
Is that a gravity death?
Can you die from fall damage in this?
You can.
No.
Yeah, you can.
No, you can't. You can die by falling off a cliff, but not by hitting the ground.
Oh, so okay.
All right, this time I'm gonna focus.
So gravity death, but no gravity damage.
You guys should listen.
Right.
Oh yeah.
Gravity
yeah.
death, but no gravity damage.
That's a good way of putting that. Actually.
See, I'm really proud of everything I've learned. I know that a lot of you guys probably have heard all this crap before, but.
I'm gonna get real now, and I'm not gonna screw around, and I'm gonna beat this. I'm gonna show everyone what I'm made of. This is what I've been working for. How many years have I been doing nothing but playing video games? Ian's just walking all over the place.
Hi.
I'm not really getting a lot of support from my co-host right now. I think what we're gonna do at some point is we're gonna set Dan up so that every time Dan plays a game, like no matter what, it's gonna stream to Twitch. We're gonna set up a special channel, maybe just call it Dan Plays Poorly, and you can just kind of hang out and watch when Dan is in his bedroom at 5 o'clock in the morning and can't sleep and wants to walk around The Witcher. But you're gonna see a lot of him kind of staring at bodies of water, maybe just mindlessly. I gotta say, I wasn't expecting this game from the trailers. Those trailers originally, when they showed basically just a string of glory kills, was one of the most disappointing things I'd ever watched. And I was absolutely taking a dump on this game as often as I could before it came out, because it really...
You did say it was going to be bad.
It was looking like it was going to be a complete train wreck.
I remember you were talking, and I thought there's no way it could be bad.
You didn't even know it
came
out.
No, I did. No, we talked about it. I said, well, there's a new Doom. And I said, that's got to be pretty cool.
Are you kidding? Did I just almost die? All right, I'm back. Dying, you know, dying when you're playing by yourself.
Hey, Chancellor Zoot says that Virgil looks handsome.
Oh.
Dan on that Walden shit. Nice. What's Walden shit?
You just
damn,
swore
that just
twice?
Cost me 2 swears.
50 cents out of you, baby.
What do you even miss?
If you miss, you gotta put another coin in.
No, that's not part of the rules.
The floor coins get swept up at the end.
What's Walden? Like the Thoreau?
Walden. Wasn't that a bookstore?
Well, it's Thoreau, one of the most famous writers. Civil Disobedience.
Do you look like that person?
Maybe he sits in a chair, but I mean, he sits by a pond.
He probably sits in a chair.
He sits by a pond.
He sits by a pond?
There's a couple of game series that have their own separate leaderboard site that most people use, but speedrun.com is kind of the biggest one.
I don't know what they're talking about,
but...
One of the things you need to... Dan, you would love speedrunning.
No,
I
don't.
It is the most fun thing.
I would like to watch it.
Watching.
Yeah.
I'd have a really good time with that.
Well, that's when I watched the speedrun of Dark Souls 3. And I enjoyed that.
You did.
I watched a speedrun.
And then you asked me if you should play it, and I said, absolutely
not. Well,
I knew
it's not, because I'm not good at fighting in games.
Am I just running in circles?
You're in one of those Doom levels where you just get stuck.
Oh, no, I got it. Just got to follow the dot. I remember this part. You got to go pull it out of the dude's hand. This is one of my favorite things
What's
in this game.
What's going on over here, freak show?
Yeah,
it's too dark?
Yeah.
Well, we got a lot. Man, we got a lot of last-minute tweakings going on here.
Well, freak show's acting nuts.
Mm.
This Where's really the good. Shot of Jason? Oh, I see it.
All right. So, in a minute, I'm going to have to pee, and Dan's going to take over.
I'm
going to
take over for you on this game. That's going to be really embarrassing. I don't want to do that.
Hey, Virgil, would you rather do it?
No.
Virgil,
that means you're up, Dan.
All right, but I don't even know the buttons.
Look at all this. How do you throw grenades again? L? There she goes.
L is...
Ha! You can be good with the controller. The one thing, you know, one of the very few things that I miss about console gaming is knowing that when I played a multiplayer game that everyone was using a controller. Because if you play Doom Online with a controller, you're going to get snuffed. It's going to be ridiculous.
Because everyone else is using keyboards.
Everyone's using keyboards. You're going to get absolutely laced.
Are they, like, sitting at battle stations?
Dan's recently discovered what a battle station is, which is, you know, when people... dust their desk for 6 hours and then put a bunch of LEDs on it.
And then put a picture of like Tokyo on
you
the
put
desktop.
A picture of a, you know, you put a picture of a stormtrooper that's turning into snow.
Yeah.
And that's then you your have background.
Like, and you have like a fancy knife that somebody made on your keychain with like a braided monkey's fist knot. And you're like, here's my battle station. Why did you hit the pause?
Because I want to talk about for a second that I'm really upset that in this game these things are really helpful.
What are they?
They give you stuff, but when you take your thing from
they're
them,
they're kind of like Freak Show.
When you when you take your item from them, he punches it. Watch,
well, do it.
Watch. I pick my thing. I like the charge burst. Let's buy it.
Oh, so it's like.
And then he runs away because he's sad. Look.
Freak Show, do you want me to move the cactuses?
I thought he ran.
He's over here.
I guess he just hangs out.
I have these cacti
can
here.
Can you shoot it?
That are on my windowsill and my radiator and.
What's the point?
Freak Show's over here trying to fix the camera. You're sitting on the radiator now? I have crystal balls over here.
Can people see him on the radiator? Because I think that they would like to see that.
I don't know if they can. He's supposed to be operating the camera.
What's being changed right now exactly?
ISO.
Oh, that's ISO. It? It takes a radiator sit to fix an ISO?
Well, because these cameras are all set to factory settings.
Oh, look, I like these guys, these big honkers.
If anybody out there is a camera nerd, we're shooting on 4 C300s tonight.
Is anyone out there a camera?
C300 Mark I's. Well, maybe you could become a crossover. If you're into video games, maybe you could get into cameras, which is all I know about.
Well, you're learning.
Look at that. It's so gross with all the death.
It's really. This is the most visceral, satisfying game I think I've played in years.
The gore-wise.
Maybe ever.
If you like gore.
No, just pure satisfaction. Like, the feeling you get in your body playing this game is like you've been satisfied. You're
okay.
Happy.
Freak Show, they say you're good.
Great.
No, the nickname?
Get out of the plants, get out of the weeds.
Thank you for the nickname, sir.
Now, maybe you should grab the camera and show people what you're just up against.
Yeah, give everyone a shot of the radiator. Oh, my God. See, dying from bad enemies like this is so...
What's a bad enemy?
Like, just like a crappy zombie. You can barely walk, and he's not getting anything done.
Oh, you want to die from, like, bosses.
And you walk into it, and it dies. When those kill you...
Oh, hey, Virgil, can you make Charlotte our next guest?
Wait, no. Isn't she coming on second?
Well, they're going to come at the same time.
Really?
Well, I don't know. I think so. Well, she just got here, and she would like a daiquiri.
You could bring it out for her.
If you could make a daiquiri, that'd be great.
Look at this guy. He's about to get it. I'm just trying to show people you can play Doom in ultraviolence, wow, with a controller and be happy.
Well, let's see how I do.
I mean, I'm doing pretty well.
I thought you had to use the head.
Holy cow.
On a boat, a bathroom is called a head. I don't know why, but it is.
Shit.
You got snuffed.
I almost threw it in my daiquiri.
Dude, hear me that, and you can use the head.
I'm going to leave my mic on so everyone can hear me pee.
No, mute it. There's a mute switch on top of it. All right, so I'm all alone here with Virgil. I don't know him. All right, so I... full disclosure, everyone, I am very, very, very bad at video games. I don't know how to do anything. How do you jump? It doesn't seem like you can jump. I think Jason was cheating when he did that. That's how you hit something. This is going to make everyone tune out. Hey, Twitch, how do you jump? Oh, somebody just made a Jinx quote. That's pretty good. Faux Ben, sounds like you're pretty knowledgeable about this stuff. Billy VO's watching. Yo, what up, Billy VO? Hey, does somebody on Twitch want to tell me how to jump? Because I don't know how. I think this is some stuff. Boat Party has lavalier mics. They got the pull at psych. Vice even. How do you jump? I'm serious. I don't know. I've never played this before, and I don't play games. Oh, wait, I think I just jumped. Oh, it's A. That makes sense, like Mario.
Shit.
Jason!
What?
I just found out that the Mario and Doom are the same in that A is jump.
They're almost the same game. Can you hear me?
Why am I already dead?
Does this work?
All right, nobody wants to watch me do this because it's really fucked up.
Damn it.
Swearing is expensive.
You gotta work on that. How long have you been playing this for?
I didn't get very far.
Is it a boring amount of time to play this game for? Yeah, we're at 7:30. Let's fire out. It's time to go Dan mode. Or maybe we bring in a guest for 15 minutes. We'll get Mark in here. And then we bring Charlotte in.
Well, I think you're overthinking it. What do these guys want? Hey, what do you... What is a favorite hipster? Cease? Oh, Vice. Is that what you guys call Vice? Is Sice?
Sice? It's a typo, Dan.
No, but somebody else said Sice earlier.
We heard Jason Mario swear when he's Doom off camera.
Mario and Doom is literally the same game.
I never seen John Wick.
Alright.
Did I just quit Doom?
Alright, guys, look at the menu of the games we have installed.
I think it's time for, although I think maybe The Witcher is for what Charlotte's here, you can have a good time in that and show her what it's all about.
Okay.
My mic just fell.
Well then,
I'm a real disaster on the microphone.
Then
stuff.
Let's,
Well, I found it.
Get Mark and play Shadow Warrior.
That'll be fun.
Yeah.
Alright, drag that dingus in here. Actually, you know what? Tell him to bring his chest with him. We'll just explore that a little bit.
Well, no, that's for at the end.
No, I want to explore that now. People want to see it. Mark brought a chest of treats for us to look at.
But that's two things. I was going to have him show you Shadow. You're going to show him Shadow Warrior.
Do you guys want to see Shadow Warrior? Okay, yeah. We'll do Shadow Warrior.
Yeah, Shadow Warrior.
This person's voting Garfield. Garfield's
that's
for
later.
That's
a wild list. It kind of is.
All right, they're dragging Mark in, I think.
All right, we're getting Mark.
We'll fire up Shadow Warrior because I think people are
Default gonna... Prophet. Okay.
Don't worry. Garfield is definitely coming. It's going to be played. There's
we're
no
definitely
doubt.
Playing Garfield. That's the main reason that we did this stream. I'm secretly the benefactor of Jim Daniels, or
is that his name?
Is that Garfield's creator, Jeff
Daniels is an actor who's in the newsroom.
Jim Garfield, and then he's invented Garfield, and I get all the money from it because of certain reasons.
Give me your pack. I lost mine.
And hey, here's Mark.
Oh, Mark, welcome to the table.
Yeah, I love it.
This is a good friend of mine. I've known him 17 years. This is Mark, and he's brought a very special something with him. Are we going to sit Mark here? Yeah.
The chest can...
Leave the chest.
The chest can be there.
You don't want it on my lap?
We're going to talk about it in a minute. Have a seat.
Mark. You guys are smoking cigarettes.
Can you whip up? Oh, look at that.
We have one waiting for you. Honestly, I come in here. Why would I even go to a bar? Why would I go out?
Because usually we don't do this. And you don't
I'm
usually get
to put this whole area over
if
here.
You spill on that controller,
don't
do you know?
Spill on the controller. Jesus
crickets. We're already off to a bad start.
We have the.
I just walked in. You guys are already yelling at me.
If you guys remember, anybody who watched the original stream, we have the Gigabyte anti-static wristband that we're gonna wear right now, so I don't blow the controller out.
It'd be great if the Boat Boys managed to get Waypoint banned off Twitch with genital jousting.
I
know Sigs, the real Dan Meyer. Who's the real Dan Meyer?
The person's name is the real Dan Meyer.
Listen, hold on a second. The controllers could blow up if you didn't wear that.
Yeah, it's the carpet. You rub your feet on the carpet.
If you're building a computer, you need to wear these anti-static wristbands so that you don't shock the processor.
But you could also shock controllers.
You can.
This is information for gamers. We have a lot of information for gamers on this show, and I feel like
it's a gaming-related show. I don't even know.
Yeah, he knows. You know a lot of stuff, but not that.
Look, nobody cares, Jason. Fire up Shadow Warrior 2. We're going to play this game because we think it's also graphically interesting.
It is. It's good. It's
and and this is kind of what this episode is about, is games that are graphically interesting.
I can we talk for a minute about the humor, if I could put that in air quotes, in Shadow Warrior? How painful. Can you see this? Is this working on the stream? Because we were having trouble streaming this earlier.
This game's called
Are you good out there seeing that? The humor in this game is so obnoxious with the self-referential...
The Sigs are very controversial in the comments.
Let's fight about cigarettes in the comments. Duke it out, everybody.
Oh, you just cursed.
Wait a minute.
Have you cursed? No, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. You're fine. Is that your stack of change?
Yes, that's mine. That's what I was looking for.
What do you have there?
Who's the real Dan Meyer?
Did they steal my... 1, 2, 3, 4. They didn't steal my $5 worth of golden coins.
So you have five swears.
Right. Whoever
$5.
The real Dan Meyer is out there, I put the cigarette out for you.
I can swear five times, guys.
You might be my subconscious or self-conscious or something kind of conscious.
That's
So I'm done smoking for
smokers,
now.
Smokers or jokers. You guys don't know that Dan had about a pack before the show started.
I was a little nervous.
I was just gonna ask for a
Dan's,
cigarette.
Dan's at like...
You guys are talking over each other. It sounds like gobbledygook.
Dan's at like a pack a day. And I think everyone at Twitch should talk to him about it because he's not going to live long. And he said that in the original stream. If you can get it down to like 5 a day, it would be really helpful for you.
All right. So, Mark, you are Jason's good friend from grade school.
Yeah.
And you're here tonight because you guys grew up playing games together as friends.
To all honesty, considered. It was probably 8th or 9th grade that we became friends. We've known each other our whole lives.
And listen, I would like you to not say anything about your my history. Life at all.
Why? You had a great mullet back then.
Okay,
I was
so.
I looked at, we so were at church, and he walked by, and I'm like, that right. guy's got a good mullet.
So Jason had a good mullet. I don't doubt that for one second.
His dad had one.
Mark is here because these guys have a great gaming chemistry. This show is also about friendship. And we're here to show Mark. New game called Shadow Warrior 2.
We wanted to bring you in for this.
And we wanted to show Mark this game and maybe talk about how it looks, how it plays. Our first impression is that it's a really fun game. It looks really great. The light is good. The reflections are awesome, as you can tell. But it is crippled by a very sophomoric,
unnecessary
sort of humor.
I've talked about this on the internet, and I've been like, hey, does anybody else think that they need to tone down the humor in like, this game? And I got ripped to shreds.
You got shredded on Reddit?
It wasn't Reddit, it was a forum though.
What forum was it?
I don't want to get into what I'm visiting.
Okay.
People are going to sniff me out.
Or the back alleys of the internet.
I was on the dark web talking about Shadow Warrior 2 with people.
And you got made fun of because you didn't like
the humor. Because I said the humor's bad, and they're like, oh, you need to grow up, or you need to get a thicker skin.
Do they think you're PC?
It's not insulting. The humor's not insulting me. It's just not funny. And it's kind of cringy. Like the Wangopedia. Look up there. Wanglopedia.
Well, because isn't your character's name Wang?
His name's Wang, and they have games like Enter the Wang.
Like dick jokes and... See, it works on you.
It's a.
Yes. I think that's funny. Wangopedia.
It's not. So it's. And then also,
you
know.
Did you send me that Wangopedia? I'd start laughing.
You did, but you also like Freddy Got Fingered.
No, I didn't like that. I thought that movie was bad.
I watched it last night for the first time.
With all the sausages.
You liked it?
I watched it for the first time last night.
Dan watched it start to finish at 3 o'clock in the morning last night.
I was so nervous about this stream today.
He needed to unwind.
And I texted my friend Dr. Luke Donnelly, MD. And
this guy's right. He says the original Shadow Warrior is the same way. He's 100% right. And I get that it was like that, but
Dan type that with a keyboard? Listen, the real Dan Meyer is not me. Everyone on the stream, the real Dan Meyer is not me.
Can somebody tell me how to
play this
game?
I don't know who it is.
Who? How do you even change weapons in this? Oh, there we go.
Yeah, now you're cooking.
By the way, I have never played this game. And whoever got to this level wasn't me. Dylan, were you playing this? I think our producer was playing this, and that's...
His name's Turtle.
I think Turtle was rocking this out. I'm getting absolutely creamed.
I'm gonna say, this game's not too bad.
It wasn't too bad. What I just did, I mean.
You have to hit that thing.
You have to
hit that doorknob.
Something about this game is a little bit janky. Like, if you stop for a second, look at the animation on the hands. It kind of is like, it's like 10
Twitchy.
Frames. It looks really odd. And we thought something was wrong with it at first until we started walking and it looked fine.
And maybe the guys had too much coffee.
We tried to run this in HDR.
You guys remember that old independent comic book, Too Much Coffee Man?
Was that a comic?
Yeah. It was kind of like...
who would read that comic?
Johnny the Homicidal Maniac.
Do
you ever read indie
about.
Comics growing up?
I read. I remember Johnny the Homicidal Maniac.
Yeah, there was a comic kind of like that.
Squee?
Yeah, Squee was...
Was it Squee?
He had his own... Yeah.
And then he was the Invader Zim guy.
Yeah.
Zim really turned into a real...
But there was a guy named Too Much Coffee Man, and I think that is who Wang is.
Can I use a sword? Is that more fun?
I think so.
I would like to use the sword.
This is unreal how bad I am at this.
What are you talking about? You're doing great. What do you mean?
I really love this. The invisible ninja thing, this whole cyberpunk vibe. There's not a lot of cyberpunk.
Do you think this is cyberpunk?
This is cyberpunk. And that's an aesthetic that people are always arguing about what is and isn't. Because, you have a rainy street, and you have some green lights, and you have some Japanese writing on a
Tokyo.
Sign. And that's cyberpunk.
That's Tokyo.
It's like Red Steel. It's a really...
Or Blade Runner.
1,000% better Red Steel.
Is Jesus a swear?
It depends on where you're from.
We're not going to consider that a swear.
No. It's not a universal swear.
Okay, so now this is fun. So, this is the most cyberpunk aesthetic that I've seen in a game in a really long time. I mean, Deus Ex obviously is just pure.
Oh, look, this person says it's definitely cyberpunk.
Yeah. But in general, I mean...
Billy doesn't like this game.
Yeah, Billy VO, by the way, for anybody watching this, he lives with us. He is...
Let's not talk about Billy right now. Jesus is a swear, pay up. Default Prophet has been a pretty good commenter.
Oh, that's right. We have to. Oh, all right.
Yeah.
We're gonna listen to a good commenter. Default Prophet. Jesus is now a swear.
Jesus is a swear, pay up. We just did.
He's saying Mark needs a mic.
God damn it!
I don't know how we're gonna do that.
That's a buck for the swear jar.
That's one big bone.
We are also, by the way, keep an eye on the Twitch chat because we're going to have a Twitch user of the day.
You guys don't need to be both smoking at the same time.
Aren't you smoking?
No, I did, but it wasn't like, let's all smoke.
Well, there you go, Tim.
Well, I wanted to smoke a cigarette.
I know you did, but you were in the other room for a half hour. You could have smoked then.
I can't smoke in there. I can smoke in this room. I can't smoke in the other room.
You definitely cannot smoke in the other room.
Yeah, so I wanted to smoke in this room. Hi, Dan. I'm Mark. We're friends. I want to smoke with you.
Turtle, we don't have a long XLR to put a mic on Mark.
I don't think we want to put a mic on Mark, to be honest with you. I think it's better to just let him...
Why don't we crank the... I can crank the shotgun on this camera up here.
This game's actually really cool. I feel like I should spend some time with this game.
I guess Dan doesn't want to smoke a cigarette.
We have... Oh, cutscene, great.
It's getting a little too smoky.
Cutscenes are just the absolute worst.
Channel one.
I got a lot of text messages.
Hey, how are we doing with Mark on this one? Hey, Mark, talk a little bit.
Hey, how you doing? I'm Mark. I'm talking just
Are you suddenly really Italian?
Hey, how you doing? I can turn it up on my end. There All right. you go. Hey,
All right, yo, what up, YouTube? We got Mark a little bit louder now.
What up, YouTube?
All right, now we're in a cutscene. Is
can I skip it? Oh, look. Boink. It's over.
You got a shotgun.
Turns out our roommate Braden Olson is the real Dan Meyer.
He has been the whole all along.
All along.
Good. Isn't there a dodge in this? Can somebody on the internet on Twitch tell me how to dodge in this game? I know there is one. Like a quick dodge.
Hey, Belmo San's on.
Please somebody tell me how to dodge.
If anybody wants to say hi to Belmo San, you should. I'm not gonna say who it is, but it's a very important person.
Belmo San is an important man.
A very important man, don't say anything bad about Belmo San.
No, I agree.
He just shot his legs and his head came off.
Without Belmo San, this show doesn't exist.
So, I really like this game. I'm enjoying it. And the fact that I can skip the cutscenes is a really big bonus because I don't have to listen to the nonsense. Has anybody played through this game and can tell me if all the cutscenes are full of Wang humor?
Wang humor?
That's what this is. The whole game is Wang humor, the whole thing. Oh, I have to go down there, it looks like.
Just click left to dodge.
You can't die from
fall.
Oh,
but we're on a...
Nailed it. You see that jump? You saw that jump.
We gotta get... Can I throw out some people we want to get on this show?
Yeah, who do we want? Look at that, it's telling me to go under.
I want
to
get...
I want Tim Allen.
Yeah, we want Tim Allen.
Tim Allen, when we first pitched this show and it was in its design stages and we wanted to do it and it wasn't even going to happen yet, the first thing I said is that I wanted Tim Allen on this show. He builds things. Oh, God almighty. This is crazy.
He builds things, and also you can have him play the home improvement game.
For what system was that?
I think it was SNES.
We can also watch the compilation of his grunts.
Should we turn the game down a little bit?
Is it too loud?
It's a little bit loud. It's making me pretty upset.
How's that? SNES home improvement game.
If I could have Tim Allen playing the home improvement game with me on a stream, I feel like I would have hit that.
Joe Rogan loves Doom.
I would have peeked out. Joe Rogan loves it?
Tim Allen is a Trump supporting.
Is he?
We're not talking
We
about
don't
it.
Talk politics in this show, so it wouldn't matter. He wouldn't be like.
I'd love to if we can.
I'm really concerned about this scene because I'm getting wrecked. How do I switch to the sword? Can I just do it?
Phil Collins would be good.
Yeah, you've
got six. Phil
Why don't you guys tell us who you want to see on the show?
Yeah.
Home Improvement was for SNES.
You know who I want.
The Prophet is. They know what they're doing.
You know who I want is I want.
Do your best Tim Allen impressions. I got one. It goes like this. And that's not where
Mark,
we're going with the
show.
Mark,
that was brutal.
That sounded like a Mortal Kombat.
Mine was a little bit.
That did sound like Mortal Kombat.
None of them were good. Virgil, let's hear your... All right, now, this is enough for the Tim Allen impersonations. This is. I hope they don't use this for the highlight reel.
I thought he was in the room.
Virgil, that was...
Austin's on vacation.
Is he? You think Austin's watching?
All right, they want to see Gerard Butler.
Hey, Gerard Butler, be good.
What's he gonna do? What games are he gonna play?
Turtle,
the 300 game.
Turtle, I hope you're writing down all these recommendations because it's your job to get these people on.
Yeah, we want Gerard Butler and Tim Allen on the same episode.
Everyone, just email turtle@waypoint.com, and then your guests will be reality.
What?
I want to get the entire cast of Moana on the show.
So you want Dwayne The Rock Johnson on the show?
Yeah, mostly just him.
Is it possible to die in this game? Because I am doing awful, and I haven't died.
I think you're on easy mode.
I'm not. It said hurt me plenty was the
just
most.
Just like you.
Or hurt me a lot, or I'm not afraid of being hurt, whatever it was.
Just like the heartbreak.
Well.
Am I wearing you out, Dan?
No, I'm just kind of having a moment to myself to think about
oh, look,
life.
If you hit B, the sword comes out. This is nice.
No more on Freak Show. What does that mean?
Oh, don't.
I'm getting text messages from Turtle.
You're not.
Even though he's right outside the door.
You can come in here and tell
I'm
Dan.
Breaking to... every fourth wall, even though it's just a doorway.
You're breaking the open door.
Yeah, I'm breaking the open door. I guess I can't talk about Freak Show. He's upset.
You can't say that because if a person is in a Freak Show.
Or maybe they're saying Freak Show's not shooting anything.
I can't reach some of these people.
This is a little bit frenetic for me.
I don't really understand how you die in this game because, like I said, I'm just running into everything now. I'm going to just get killed because I'm done with this game.
Try to actually die?
No, I think I'm just done with it because I don't really...
Well, just play until you die.
I don't
just
know how to play
stand there and commit suicide.
I don't know how to play this game. I don't know how to get bullets.
You know how to play this game. You're doing wonderful. You're shooting people.
Look at this. What is going on there?
What is this story? What is this story?
That's so cool. This is there's so many cool ideas in this. It's really, really awesome.
But Billy doesn't like it.
I don't know what his problem is. You know what he plays? He plays Star Wars Battlefront.
Yeah, and he doesn't like a lot of things.
And he plays Star Wars Battlefront on his SLI 780s, and he thinks that that's...
The hell's the matter with Star Wars
Battlefront? Oh, play Turok, Turok, Turok.
All right, that's up next.
All right, die and play Turok. That's what we're going to do.
Should I die?
Yeah, die. Well, that was easy.
Although Star Wars Battlefront doesn't have very much going on with it.
Hey, you know what would be a funny game about...
It's a simple...
A brewery game?
What are you doing?
It'd be called Stout Wars Battlefield. And it'd be a bunch of dudes with handlebar mustaches.
And they all...
And like...
It sounds like games of New York.
And like rare tall dogs. And they would be like homebrew...
Rare tall dogs.
You know what I mean? Like homebrew guys. And they'd be like homebrewing different stouts. And then they would all get together and with their tweed jackets and pretending that they were like something.
If
they would all get together and be like, try my stout, try my stout. It would be this battlefield of...
No one... If that was a
Stout Wars Battlefield.
If that was a free to play game,
hey, Bethesda,
on Steam,
you can have that idea for free.
It.
It's going to sell big in the session beer and lager community.
So, wait, Mark, can we see what Mark brought us? Well, first, let me introduce a piece of hardware.
You do that, and I'm going to hit the head again.
Are you kidding?
I drank so much water before this show.
Are you even a part of this stream?
I'm so nervous.
Why don't you take Dan's seat while he gets up? It's a good shot.
Sure, whatever.
Show the only thing. Yeah. Oh, yeah, and then we're going to get Freak Show on the wide angle.
Don't say that anymore. You gotta throw a coin in every time you say Freak Show now. Hey? Oh, this is good, actually. Get in here. So, this was gifted to us. I reached out to Chris, who is a very big part of the production of these systems called the Analog NT. And this is a system that plays original NES games, it plays Famicom games, and it is fully 100% perfectly hardware compatible with all Nintendo stuff. And I'm not really into the NES in general. You're into Nintendo.
Oh, I love it.
That's his thing. But I never was. But now this thing has inspired me kind of to get into that scene because it's such a beautifully designed. Do you see the bottom of this? It's this beautiful transparent bottom with, I mean, you have like a gold inlaid logo for the company. The whole thing is aluminum. It feels so good. It's a really high-end thing, and it came in a box that felt like opening an iPhone.
It's beautiful.
The box just slides open, and all the stuff is in there so nicely. It's the nicest design system. It sounds like I'm shilling for this thing, but realistically, I wanted the big one that they had, and now they just introduced the mini. So I just reached out to him, so I want to thank him for sending this our way. We're going to be doing a retro episode down the line. We're going to be bringing Mark back for this, and... When that episode comes around, we're gonna be doing a lot of playing on this thing, and this is gonna become our go-to retro system. So that's what we're looking at.
That's what we're gonna be utilizing, whatever we're going to be playing right now. It's the machine itself is incredible. It's probably one of the most top-of-the-line systems I've ever seen in my life.
It's amazing.
Yeah,
and it comes with these amazing wireless controllers, too. These 8-bit-do wireless NES pads.
By the way, it's not emulation at all. It's FPGA, which is a field programmable gate array.
It's something different, right? I don't understand how it works.
In that sense, I don't understand it, but the chip itself doesn't emulate it, but it acts as if it does all the components of how that system.
It's a simulation, they call it, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so really, I mean, it's just really cool. It's called, somebody asked what it was called. It's called the Analog NT. And you can look it up.
Mini.
It's really mini. I know that they're sold out right now. From what I understand, they're sold out. But I'm looking forward to getting into that. But that's why we actually wanted. I was going to do this in episode one, but we're having troubles with the feed through the system. So what we're going to do is have Mark. Why don't you bust this thing out?
Sure.
Let's take a peek at what's in there.
I got no problems doing that.
Can you get in there with this? Can you get in there with this thing?
I brought a wide variety of games here.
Let's sit down and take a look.
This is supposed to be what I carry luggage in, but guess what? This is the only luggage I carry.
What's going on in here?
we have a wide variety of games.
And I'm going to play Turok while we have this
going.
We
have reproductions right here. Yeah. This is a hack/reproduction. This is a fan-made game by Flashback Entertainment. They make wonderful things. But this game took 4 years to make. It's a Legend of Zelda game. Fantastic. We're going to test a few things here. We have a 501 NES.
We're card. Not testing that.
You know, why not? It's good.
I don't want these trashy compilation carts going in my beautiful Analog NT system.
It's not going to make it dirty or anything.
Where did you even buy that?
It's canned air. Oh, wait, maybe the Billy B.O.
Canned air. Like baseball.
And,
you know, we have...
Do you have the Barbie game?
Bubble Bobble 2. It's worth about...
Someone's asking if you have the Barbie game.
I don't think I brought the Barbie
game. You have it, though.
You should have told me. I would have brought it. I do have the Barbie game. I would have brought it. But I have a wide variety of NES games here.
Oh, hey, Marky, we're going to give you a mic.
Oh, you finally earned a mic.
All right, hold that in your hand.
Just keep it on the table.
Until when you move, don't forget to bring it with you.
Okay.
So... You have Famicom in here too, right?
I do. I have Famicom games here. Certain Famicom games with the original Nintendo. There's an expansion port on the bottom of it that allowed for extra expansion, like two or three FM channels. But unfortunately, they never utilized it because there were no expansions on the bottom of Nintendo. But this beautiful Analog NT Mini has all of that.
I know. He said now it looks like he's shilling hard. We're already getting in trouble.
Hey, why not? Anyway, it plays all the expansion sound, yeah. And it's kind of interesting.
I really did want to test it out.
How it does sound. Because,
well, I just gave him my mic.
Here's, for instance, here's Pokemon Yellow. This is a Game Boy game that was only released, obviously, on the Game Boy. But this is it for the regular Nintendo. And supposedly, it's the same game as Pokemon Yellow.
It's a little bit shady.
It's
a little shady.
A little shady, but you know, not too bad.
All right, get back over here.
I'm done? All right.
But well, we're going to go back. We're going to play a little Turok now.
Okay.
And we're going to discuss Turok.
We're going Turok, and I have a bunch.
And after Turok, we're going to go Witcher and bring Charlotte.
Tell everyone we only have two mics, and then we're just going to trade them back.
Oh, wait, we only have two microphones, so give that back to Danny Boy.
Awesome.
And we're going to trade them back and forth.
You want to take this one?
Mark had important things to say, and we needed to hear them.
Well, this is going to be, we're going to do a whole episode about vintage gaming in the future. We just wanted to show you guys some of the equipment we have and cartridges that we have to play that.
We're on a
tonight. Bunny. Tonight is about high-tech gaming, so that's why we're playing Turok.
Like Turok Dinosaur Hunter for the Nintendo 64.
No, tonight's about the boat, but if you guys tune in later, we're going to be doing a lot of stuff with vintage games as well, because the show is about technology as well as about gaming itself. So. We're just giving you a little teaser of that with this. And speaking of technology, we only have two wireless mics tonight.
We're gonna get more.
Not sure why.
Once we hit it big and have.
Well, I mean, I have more mics at the office, but we just didn't really think about it.
We didn't think about a lot of things. I feel like.
Well, we did think about a lot of things.
We thought
a lot of things to think about.
We're off the cuff.
This is how you do a dinosaur. That's it, right there.
I've never seen this game. I've never played Turok Dinosaur Hunter. I've never seen anything. So it's like a peak of Turok Dinosaur Hunter. It's no peak for me. It's just this is the full fledged.
I'm surprised that you never saw this back in the N64 days. It was huge.
I never had an N64. When my buddy Jim Buse brought it over, the only thing I played was Shadows of the Empire and Mario 64.
Shadows of the Empire just made its way, or is making its way, to Steam, like, now, I think. It was in a Humble Bundle, which is surprising because when I saw the bundle, it hadn't even appeared on Steam yet, but it said it gave you a Steam key. So I thought about picking that up because I really would like to play through Shadows. People grilled that game. Yeah. It didn't get, you know, it didn't get put over, but I feel like the test of time, it's got that cheesy.
Shaking it up.
I guess Turtle ordered a drink or something.
Shadows of the Empire has that. It has that vibe of being that kind of like mid-90s style, which I really like. My other favorite stylist is like...
This is for Mark? Who's this for?
This is for Mark.
You're just hooking him up?
He's the bartender, is he not?
Virgil. Oh, he says finish it.
Oh. Well, don't chug it.
Well, that could be a segment on the show called Finish Him.
I didn't chug it.
We just play Mortal Kombat and finish each other?
But the thing about what was so explosive about it was a mixture of first-person combat, and then you had space combat as well.
Well, it had a lot of everything. It had a little bit of everything, which is really what made it special.
It was wonderful. It was great. And then I think it was one of the first games to have the Hoth battle.
What are you guys even talking about?
I think Hoth, no, because you know what? I had it in Intellivision way back in the day. So Intellivision, Dan, was kind of a competitor for Atari systems.
Intellivision.
My father had an Intellivision, and I played The Empire Strikes Back on the Intellivision.
Mark. Oh, thank you.
And it was...
Don't spill that.
I'm not spilling it.
It's just going to go on the couch.
Virgil, would a Hemingway Daiquiri normally have a lime wedge? Or like a lime...
Yeah, what's going on with the lime wedges?
It would have a lime wedge.
I'm not normally would have a lime. Yeah.
So we don't have those.
We don't have any...
Are you fighting dinosaurs with a knife?
Yeah, this is how you should fight a dinosaur.
Yeah, that's how you fight. They don't have guns. Why should you?
Yeah.
You have a bow and arrow, though.
Yeah, neither do they.
I'm playing like a man. Anybody on here saying anything interesting?
I'm playing like a strong person.
Is anyone saying anything interesting in the chat? Because we should acknowledge interesting comments.
What idiot would think Dan rules?
No, that's not very nice.
I don't know.
You know, Billy V.O.
Oh, it's Billy V.O.
No, we're not going to give him the...
We shouldn't read any more Billy V.O. comments.
Yeah, because he's just trolling. He should be called Billy Trollo.
Billy... Look at this. This game was surprising because those violent deaths...
I thought you just shot that guy.
Those violent deaths were a big deal. For the N64.
I thought you were going to stab people.
Nintendo was kind of coming from a squeaky clean image, and they went to the 64, and this game was so violent.
I don't know how squeaky this is, buddy. You stabbed
Like people. I said, this was their emergence.
That's not squeaky, but it's...
You've got to be kidding me.
But you hit the water, though. You're okay.
No, I'm fine.
So what is this? You just climb up whatever wall you want?
Just the ones that are covered in vines.
Those are vines.
He's Indian.
What does that mean, Mark? Mark, you have to back yourself up if you're going to say something like that.
I'm part Algonquin. I can say it.
Are you really?
That doesn't mean much.
Really?
Bullshit. I'm 0.001%.
I'm part poor, but that doesn't mean I can make fun of poor people.
I'm not making fun of everybody. My people can climb vine.
Okay. We're going to change the subject here real fast.
We really got to vet these guests better for the next show. Yeah, Mark's cut off on Daiquiri. He's going to move on to undisclosed blue-labeled beers.
Look, you guys
So this is a big moment. This guy, this is a lot of fun.
Dan Rules 420. I like that sub. I like that name. Does this game become fun at any point? I don't think so.
I'm having a great time with this game. You know what we did?
We did the other night. We played this game and we were listening to Nine Inch Nails.
That was a fun experience.
And here's the thing. This is one thing I want to make clear on the stream is that we. A lot of the times when we're at home playing, what we do is we turn the game volume all the way down and we pick music to listen to. Strange combinations of music.
You want a good one.
Or good combinations of music, and it makes the game better.
The new Brian
Eno. Because of rights and clearances, we can't actually do that, but we can tell you that the best thing to listen to while you play Turok is Nine Inch Nails. What was the album?
I don't remember which one we were listening to.
It was the second big studio album.
But I do know that we
Burning
did...
Pretty Hate Machine. But it does drive you...
It makes the game more fun. And that's something you can do.
Not for all games, because Doom, I insist that we listen to that music.
Yeah, Doom
it's so perfectly...
Yeah, some games have soundtracks that are just perfect. The way they are.
Skyrim with Brian Eno was such a good...
Yeah, Skyrim with Brian Eno...
Like the new Brian Eno album. I don't know what it's called.
Reflections?
That was it.
Yeah, that's
very
good.
That was unreal.
So that's the kind of thing, if you think a game stinks, put on a different song, baby. And put on a different outfit. Maybe if you're wearing the wrong clothes, you can put on a crazy skirt.
Like a costume.
Yeah, like put on a costume. But if you put the Turok costume on, listen to Nine Inch Nails, this game would be really, really, really
Can I ask
really
why
fun.
I just opened a door back to where I already was?
Downward Spiral. That's the one we were listening to.
Was it?
That's, yeah, we were listening to Downward Spiral. That'd be really, really, really fun.
Imagine wearing a full-on Indian leather suit and sitting there. What are you doing?
I don't think you should see.
Native American, you have to say.
No, not even that. Just don't even talk about things.
The game's about a Native American.
Oh.
You play as a Native American in this game. It's a comic book series.
I don't think
you're...
You're an Indian.
Native American.
Yeah, right,
Hey, Twitch, do you guys want to see us play something else?
Yeah, so wait, let's get Witcher going.
We'll play this for a little bit longer, but let's see what you guys want to do.
I really like this game. It feels so good. It's such a smooth. You can even tell by just looking at it how smooth it is.
He's thinking it's smooth.
It's smooth.
Somebody writes Jason. Who is Billy O?
That's
our
somebody
roommate.
We don't want to discuss.
He's our roommate. We're not giving him any attention.
Don't. What are we to tell you? Don't talk about.
I'm sorry.
About Billy O.
It's okay.
What is Billy O drinking?
No. Oh, yeah,
that just now? That was an animation of me admiring the thing I just got. This guy's gonna.
What is Billy O drinking?
Billy O's probably drinking Duster.
That's why we can't clean any of our computers in the apartment.
Right. Don't play anything else ever Default Profit says.
Default Profit is really a good a
make
good
a rum user. Collins with just a half shot and extra sour mix, Thelmo Sayan says. Virgil says no.
He says no. No period on no rum Collins.
No, yeah.
So right,
I think we gotta play. Hey, you know what? We gotta play a game that,
Witcher 3.
That shows the quality of the system.
Then it's your turn to take the helm, my friend.
Oh.
Look at this, I'm just knifing it up. I hope this is kind of making up for everyone having to watch me play Shadow Warriors so badly.
I think that game was fun to watch.
I like
if I knew
game.
How to play it, I would have done
right.
it better.
All right, close out of this. We're done.
Let's play
We're
Knights.
Done. You like that game?
I love Knights.
Really?
Love Knights, yes.
I didn't know you even knew it. Oh, that's right, you have
it
a very
like
eclectic.
Turtle, it seems like Turtle and Hightower.
Early
Turtle
phase.
And.
Yeah, did they just leave?
I think Turtle and Denny are gone.
Oh, the
Denny's
bathroom.
Here.
Denny, all right, he's
Turtle
there.
Left.
Why is
I got a little scared, guys, because our team left.
Visually, it's unrivaled.
It's the visuals are pretty crazy. Mm-hmm. It's very psychedelic.
What game is that? Let me take a look.
Paul
you got
later?
Dandy. You got Doom. Flying Tigers. That sounds
more,
okay.
No more
Garfield Car.
Okay,
Count Markula. We did not finish the boat. We have one package that you might have seen. You can find it on YouTube, I think, right? It was a promo. For this episode, where Dan does some modifications to the case, and we're able to fit
Charlotte.
The GPU. And besides that, we need to saw the hole in the lid still, so we can slide it on top of the GPU. I want to do that live. Do we have the Dremel here?
Yeah, we're gonna do that later on.
I mean, but we're getting there. It's already wow. This is going quick. It's already 8:06.
That's great. It's almost over. I can't wait. I'm already over.
What are you just chain smoking now?
Yeah, put it out.
I found it.
I
found that
shit. I light it and put it out.
Why? What's
because it's too smoky in here.
Is it getting too smoky?
It's screwing up the cameras.
All right, snuff it.
No, I'm okay.
Stop feeding this guy daiquiris.
I didn't even get to hit it one more time.
That's all right,
guys. We brought in someone else. We brought in our good friend Charlotte Dubac.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Charlotte.
Hey, pal.
Come on in.
How are you?
Charlotte is a journalist at Vice. Charlotte, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Mark.
Hi, Mark.
Jason.
Very nice.
Hey.
Wow.
Would you like a what is it called? A Hemingway daiquiri?
A daiquiri.
By our bartender?
Oh, my God.
It's really
good. I've never asked. I'd love
get to work.
Please. Thank you so much.
So Dan's going to show you.
Well, so just so you guys know, Charlotte is here because Jason brought Mark, who knows a lot about video games, as you saw with his collection and his knowledge. And Jason knows a lot about video games, and I come from the side of the world that knows next to nothing about it. And so I thought I would try to find some friends at work who also know next to nothing about video games. And I asked Charlotte if she liked video games, and her reaction was she said that she wasn't allergic to them.
Is that what I said?
Yeah, you texted me. We're not allergic to them.
That's
so,
where are we?
I'm talking
all of
that.
It. Dan's got a tight, a tight camera on that one.
There's
you're
a wide
here.
Camera up there, and then there's this guy. His name's Freak Show, and he's got.
Don't can't keep saying that.
That's his name.
It doesn't matter. Somebody's name was a horrible racial slur. You wouldn't be allowed to call them that.
I didn't know his
Freak
name was Freak Show.
It's not, but I'm giving
he
you an example
that.
I'm saying that a name isn't a license to say things.
You screwed it up.
I think he might like it. Should we ask him?
Do you like that?
How do you feel about your name?
Sure.
Yeah. See. Or maybe we'll call you Sure from now on.
Sure.
All right. From now on, Freak Show's name is Sure.
I'm not allergic to this.
Really give that one up.
When I was a kid, my dad...
Wait, put the mic
here. Here. See,
this is
wait,
I'm going to
hook you
up.
Wait, 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 wait. No, no, when no. Do what I'm doing and just take it off. Because we only have two mics. And we just kind of...
My importance has been lost here.
Just a super short anecdote. When I was a child, my father bought me a PlayStation.
PlayStation
knowing
one?
That my one. Uh-huh. Knowing that my mum wouldn't let me play it, uh-huh. so that he'd get to play it. And so
oh,
it became
that's
his
smart.
PlayStation.
My dad used to have guns.
Oh my god, thank you so very much. Cheers, gang.
Cheers.
And so I did play a few games,
cheers,
which you'll probably all laugh at.
Maybe. Count Markula, we're not going to answer your question because we think you're probably... I'm not going to say what we think you're going to do.
what am I going to do?
Can that, I tell you the games I played and you can tell me
what
their
what
reputation is?
Yeah, so I'm
going to
play this. I'm going to play this.
Tomb Raider.
That's a great, great groundbreaking game.
One of the, one, two, three, I don't know, one of the numbers. Tekken, one of the Tekkens.
The yeah. Tekken 1 is still the best Tekken.
Crash Bandicoot.
We don't like
we
Crash
don't like
Bandicoot.
Crash here. We don't mess with Crash
we
Bandicoot
actually hate
here.
Crash Bandicoot.
We're not fans.
Yeah. Grand Theft Auto.
That's which one? Like the overhead one?
I don't know.
If it was PlayStation, then
I
you
mean,
must have.
This was probably like 20 years ago, I'm showing you.
It was 90. Yeah, it would have been like 95.
She's nailing all the hits, though.
Those are hits. Those are big games. All
right, so this.
So this is what Dan does when he's not doing work. This is the only thing he does.
I run around this horse named Roach.
This is beautiful.
I know, right?
Beautiful. It looks real.
Yeah, are these guys. Where am I?
The screen is legit.
Yeah, this is, Dan, you want to talk about the screen that we have in here?
Oh, it's a Sony, I forget if it's a 790 or a Z90. It's something, it's one of the best TVs.
It's a 65-inch HDR 4K
television. 4K
television. And the thing is, you're seeing this game right now.
Right,
as Dan's playing it, he's playing it at one quarter? One half. He's playing
one
it at
half
one
half
of half
the, resolution
of the sharpness that it normally is for the stream. So it's normally even more clear. It's just unreal. This is the only game that we haven't got to run at 60 frames per second on our GTX 1080 at 4K.
Is that true?
Yeah.
I don't know what you just said.
So
I feel like I'm in Game of Thrones.
Ask questions. This is ask questions.
I know,
because I'm trying to learn too.
Right.
So 4K.
Really?
Great.
Oh, this is Virgil. Have you met Virgil?
This is Virgil, our bartender.
Yes. Yeah. We did.
That's nice.
So this is.
So exactly how many frames per second we run here?
Now this person would like you to narrate everything on Waypoint.
Gallop in, gallop. I need to get off this.
They want us to get closer, Jason.
Fair enough.
So I need to get up this.
She's in.
So I don't really know what I'm doing right now. Basically, where I'm at in this game is that I shouldn't go up here because I have nothing to talk to this guy about.
Yeah, but
talk to him, though. Look what he said. I'll throw one in for him.
Swear jar. Yeah, and so.
What's the sound like? I want to hear the audio.
Yeah, turn the audio up on the game, Jason.
Got it.
So. You know, we just played a lot of really fast first-person shooter games, and this game, Witcher, is very much a slow game. You get into fights, but really what you do is a lot of running around.
Investigating.
You talk to people, and you get into different stories, and it's kind of peaceful because you just run around the countryside. I should probably get my horse back.
Call for it.
I'm gonna get
is
my horse
like
back.
This is like your favorite game.
This is definitely.
This is definitely my favorite game.
What's it
I've probably
the
logged
Witcher
like 20 something. And when I call my horse, ugh. She just comes out of wherever.
See that? She was just hanging out. In
the I know. Oh, she's always there. Her name's Roach.
She's drinking.
Oh, don't go.
Oh, wow.
Roach?
Oh my Dan, God. Come on.
But that's fun horses. Because when I used to play, if you went off the side, you couldn't really go there.
This game
that was
has
it.
No
it would
off
block
the side.
Yeah,
it's
really
this menu, and then I have the top right corner. But so you spend a long time just running down trails.
That's lovely.
And you don't have to direct it, Dan. You can just hold A and Roach will find the trail. Let go of the stick.
No way.
Yeah, I'm telling you right now that works. Watch. Just let go of the stick. Let him do it. Let Roach do it.
Just let
watch.
Hold A.
He knows where the trail is.
Oh, that's crazy. How come I never
Now double tap it and he'll just run down the trail.
How come you never told me this before?
So
I've been playing
fun.
This for so long.
Gaming secrets.
But gaming these days, you don't just play the game. There's like a whole...
Yeah,
it's
not like
this
constant
community.
Action.
Yeah, and what I'm trying to do is, I mean, Dan's been playing this very much by himself for many weeks now.
And I've gotten into some really weird situations. I had killed a ghost.
Dan's got some
food. I broke up with my girlfriend in this game.
And you did. And it's funny because you were
name
you
was
have
Yen,
a
her name was
in the
yeah,
game.
Well, she was like actually my soulmate.
They broke up.
And we were together for life because her name was Yennefer. And we had been given, like, oh, but see, it chose the wrong trail.
Did you invent her?
No. It was part of the story.
This is a real
and,
person.
And so what happened was she had made a wish, or I had made a wish on this current, previous ghost.
He loves me.
And the ghost was, whatever. Long story short, I'm trying to find my daughter, and...
Is he talking about?
This has been the game. Yeah, I've spent hours and hours.
Dan's personal life is just going off on right now.
No, I don't have a daughter.
Dan and I have both worked at Vice for far too long.
He's in therapy over this game.
That's a good run. Right. I know, Dan, you need somebody. I'm his therapist. He comes in and talks to me about it. He came in and he was having a conversation with Yennefer in the game, and he said, I really am sick of her. I think I really need to break up with her. And then a dialogue prompt came up that said, he had the option to either say, I feel the same way about you, or he had the option to say, the magic's gone for me. And when he was confronted with the situation, you sat there for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
He couldn't pull the trigger. And then he said it was in the game. And Dan was very sad.
Yeah, I don't know.
Look at you now. You're a bachelor. You're running around town.
I'm in some crazy town now.
These graphics are
unreal. So you feel okay now after the fact?
No, I'm still kind of, because she was helping me find... She was helping
he's
me find my
spaz
daughter.
When he's running, it's just a
you feel
that.
I don't feel better about much.
Spaz.
He's
still
bad.
Dan.
Dan.
The term spaz.
Spastic?
Not good.
Oh, because it's spastic.
Not good.
Spastic is...
Yeah,
so what could I replace it with?
Crazy.
He runs around like an
oh,
idiot.
Oh, I went to
Jinx.
A barber.
Moron.
Jackass.
Apparently, I'm at a barber. Wait, the screen's just frozen on barber.
You guys are being actually.
Let's elevate.
I'm getting a note from our producer that swear jar, Jason,
jackass.
That's two because I said it again to read it.
Wait, I need that on here.
What's this?
That's the swear jar.
Where does this money go?
We're
gonna
trying to decide what charity you donate
to. It goes into my pocket after the game.
Do you need donations?
How long have you all known each other?
Should we donate? I've known him for 17 years.
This is the third time I've met Mark.
Yeah, literally. Yeah,
the first time I met Mark, he was staying in Jason's room, and I made him watch Swiss Army Man with me.
Oh, Swiss Army Man.
I haven't seen
God almighty, please don't watch Swiss Army Man.
I didn't think it was that bad. He said it was one of the worst. He gave it a zero.
I gave it a one just for the
fact
that...
You don't like things that are as kooky as you are.
Get out
He's
of here.
Kooky as
I like
some
them.
I know.
Just,
alright, so I'm
you
going
see,
this
bitch.
Way. How
I
do know
put the
what?
Money in.
I thought, guys, I repeated.
So do people on Twitch like watching me just run around? Because this most of what this game is.
I mean,
should I get back
Twitch?
On Roach?
Twitch is this.
Twitch is all
the
viewers
community
are watching and
chatting with us, talking with us. Oh look, this person says we could call Dan if we don't want to say the S word. We can call him a fool.
Oh,
I like
good.
That.
Thank you.
Yeah. He's running around like a fool.
They're telling us what we can do. Hey, Dan, you're a fool.
Do you know what this is like?
I think you need to settle
this
down.
This is like webcam.
I like Dan.
We're kind of like cam girls.
We're kind of cam girls.
Or the Spice
but
Girls.
But they're not, they don't pay, if they paid us, maybe it'd get
they can pay us.
We're going to set up a tip jar next time that we...
I don't even know where I'm going.
I think that's a good idea.
They can throw dollars at us and do things
see,
they like.
And see, all right, so Charlotte, the
Hi.
Thing is, so I got some bread. All right. And so,
why?
Dan needs a breather.
Sometimes with these games, like, you get into situations where it's like things are happening, and then you go through like hour to 2 hour long stretches where there's like nothing, and you're just running around for hours. There's one night I was playing, and I was like, I was thinking about trying to find a job as a barista because I was lost in this town. And I was like lost in, I think it was, what are the main town? Some town. And I was like, I don't know. I've lost my way. Like, I had literally lost my way. And I couldn't find out what I was supposed to do. So I was like, maybe I'll just go work at a bar or something. Like, I don't know what to do.
Did you find work?
No, and then I went and I got on some side quest. And then, you remember when I was in that garden?
Oh,
and
yeah,
I had like,
to
oh my God. My ex-girlfriend in this game, she
she took the ends out.
She took me to this garden that was like owned by these like priestesses, and it was like the only place that was verdant.
Keep it going.
And no, and she.
This game has orgies
she,
though.
And she was like, oh god, then. The,
do you think you could find? And,
that shaker noise.
You know he knows just when to hit it too. Dan starts talking about his experience.
You
guys won't let me
you first. Get a drink. You keep that's drinking wine.
Because I think you could use some help.
Okay, I think
but
I'm
ordinarily when
you
play
whoa.
Is this
no, don't keep eating
Mark like
this.
This
is for me.
Don't
is
keep eating
something
Mark
that you like
me.
Play
Mark.
On your
Mark.
Own.
This is
yeah,
a single
yeah, yeah, yeah. This is a game.
But like is this normal?
I'll normally
like, you us hanging out.
I like
no,
to see
no,
how
no.
Damn he plays though.
He'll watch me play, but normally I'll be laying on the sofa
It's like Skyrim.
And it's like Skyrim, which is another famous long. No, Mark doesn't even have any more cocktails.
Oh, come on.
Mark's looking pretty well.
Okay, but I have another crucial question.
Ask the community.
Is playing computer games something that you like?
Oh, look, I'm finally at the place. I made the place I was supposed to get to.
Well, that's the thing with when you're playing games. That's the thing. And that question comes up a lot. People talk about playing games, you're wasting your time. But pretty much anything that's not furthering some kind of career decision you've made could potentially be a waste of time.
Doing this or going to...
But now we're making this a career decision.
Yes! Now you're marrying the two.
Now it's both. Now
and I think everyone should do this. And there's YouTubers who have made millions of dollars a year playing video games. And now it's, you know...
Well, the infamous, the recently infamous PewDiePie.
No, we're not talking about that.
We're not getting...
I don't want to talk about that.
We're not talking about that
too controversial?
All. Absolutely.
I told you.
The producer notes.
I see. Now I'm missing the story. So I made it, Charlotte. I made it to the place I was supposed to get to. Now this is the story, and it's very beautiful. That's me. I'm Geralt. I will never look like that.
You can live out your ideal identity.
No, that's just how
that's Dan's ideal identity, and he's be brewing beer.
Oh, that's Nick Hazen.
That is Nick Hazen.
I can never look like that. Look at his hairline. It's down here.
Plugs, baby.
Where are wings, bro?
Wait, I'm looking for a redeeming
gear. I'll give you some armor.
I wanted to talk a little bit about William Shatner's rug.
What? Now, why do you want to go on doing something like that?
Because, Mark, you said a lot of strong... You have a lot of strong opinions about William Shatner's hair.
Because sometimes it's all real. Sometimes it's shaped.
When is it?
Anytime from 1971 to 1976... It looks like somebody shot a raccoon and taped it to his head.
But after that, it's great.
Yeah.
God damn it, you guys. You were talking too much, and I don't even know what I'm supposed to do.
Help him with the band. Oh, no. Get rid of them. If you get rid of them, worse ones will come.
No point in fighting bandits.
Yeah, I don't want to fight bandits.
Dan takes the lazy man.
But you like Star Trek, boy.
I don't like Star Trek at all. I'll be right back. I'm going to hit the can. I'd like to keep my mic on and let everyone hear it, but the producer is saying absolutely not.
DS9, you can go.
Okay, hold on a second.
Now I'm having a drink for Danny.
I think the audience doesn't like me.
Danny needs a whiskey.
Very much like you.
I think the point of this is it needs to be like this needs to be a safe space for like gaming people, and it's not a place for.
Say that again.
Who? The commenters?
Yeah, they're like.
Are they mad at us right now?
They're just like, we don't really care about people who don't know about games.
Well, but that's fine. That's the name.
Don't even worry about them.
I think that these people...
Hi, Danica. Oh, it's Danica.
Danica Herod?
Yeah. Oh, thank
you. The mods keep deleting my links. Should we get... Yeah, for any of you people out there who are trying to say people who don't know about gaming shouldn't watch, then you shouldn't watch things that are non-gaming related. And see how limited that gives you in life.
Hypocrisy.
I'm all ears. Okay. Should we play something a little bit more exciting?
Do you think I could play?
Yeah, what do you want to play? What kind of game do you want to play?
What are the options?
There are options for you. You can play old school games. You can play games that
they have. What is
Knights? I like that one before, which was all green and it was like explorers.
Green? Oh, Turok.
Like
we have to play something different.
Sure.
Yeah, see, this is a very private game. Because this is my story, and this is the thing.
Yes.
What's interesting to know about this game is that people who have never played, like, everyone has a different story in this game. It's much like life. There's like, it's a tree that goes off and. Yeah, it's everything goes in different directions. And so, like, this story, like, maybe one out of 1,000 people who play this game will end up on this same storyline. So I'll get out of here.
Like your life, the decisions that you make will—that's how your life ends.
But I need to get out of here. I can't. I have to get through
Garfield.
I already played Garfield card.
Now play Garfield.
What's that?
I think we could play Thumper.
Oh, what, the cat?
People wanted to play Thumper, though.
He loves lasagna.
I love lasagna. Oh, I wish we had
lasagna. They don't have lasagna in that game.
In that
unfortunately, we did not make lasagna.
They should make a lasagna cocktail, huh?
But we got a lasagna cocktail.
Hey, Jason, how do I get out of this game?
But we do have a Garfield.
Jason?
Yes. She discharged us immediately. We actually have a Garfield.
Can I get out of here without...
Would you like to race with Garfield and lasagna?
Sure.
Can I get out of here without... we're like kind of stuck in the story here.
It's too much.
I know, but how do we hard quit this?
No, I'll play anything. I'll play anything.
How do we hard quit this?
Let's get the other controller fired up.
But how do we hard quit this game?
I know how to hard quit things.
All right, because I'm stuck in here.
I'm your boy.
But say, and I don't think you even need to save anything because I didn't make any progress.
I'm done. Sorry that
task
I'm
manager.
No, everybody wants...
That I'm late to the party, but why is this a boat party when you could...
because the computer is the boat right there.
And why is it a boat?
Because,
the truth is...
I'll tell the backstory. So, the freak show. I mean, sure. So, Charlotte...
Where should this go here?
Part of the backstory here is that...
You bought or built a model boat.
We built a boat and
a
yacht. Pier. There was, on Motherboard, there was an article that talked about how building computers was too hard and that you shouldn't do it. And
I saw it.
And Jason saw it and he sent it to me and he said, hey, look, this is weird. Like, I shouldn't be putting out articles about how hard it is to build a computer because it's actually really easy and really fun. And then we started talking about building computers, and I was like, tell me more about building computers, because I built one in 2002, and...
And you wanted Vice to film you going around on the boat.
Yeah, but that's a different story. And I've worked on boats. Boats are a big part of my life.
I see.
Yeah, it's all coming together. And so
I look into my crystal ball, and I see...
It's our crystal ball. It's in the center of the room.
I see boats.
It's in the center. And so... but anyways, see, this goes on top. I'm not going to put it on right now. But basically, Jason showed me... that there's a computer case that is in the case of a boat, and I decided we're going to build the boat for Vice's gaming channel in the boat case, and that's why it's the boat party.
It really, it started off, can you guys see this, by the way, or is this picking up?
We need Dan's mic on.
My mic is on Mark right now.
Give it back to Dan.
Well, I have to go use the head.
Hey, okay. This is your mic.
Is this picking up?
Yes.
You can see it, though.
But I'm walking.
Yeah.
I'm walking out of the room right now.
Leave it behind. Leave it behind. So, Mark told me that I should download this game. Mark told me I should download this game, Phantasmagoria.
Yes, here we go. You guys want me to fill you in on this?
A cutscene is what we. So our producer has a note. Okay, so please, God, no more cutscenes. Basically, a cutscene is when Dan was talking to other characters in the game. It was just stagnating and sitting there.
It was an absolute mess. We can't watch your intro.
Here we go, name your game.
When you play, do you play against other people in the interview?
In this game, basically what was going on.
Can't.
We moved into a
How many dead this game?
And
zoom in.
It's completely haunted, and they're trying to kill us.
Put that mic on yourself. Clip it on.
I should have.
Oh, okay.
I'm talking about that.
So take Dan's seat while he's gone.
Okay.
So, I've never played this before. Is this an old... Which chapter?
This is a 6-7 disc full motion video game.
What year did this come out?
I don't know. I want to say 96, 97.
Hold on, Mark.
Why are bikinis so expensive? Like, I don't understand.
Bikinis?
Why do they think it's okay to spend $100 for 2 times the cover?
Mark, we're going to take a break. I mean, this is boat related because when you're on a boat, you're going to have bikinis.
Sure.
Why are bikinis? What's the most you've ever paid for a bathing suit?
Probably
$150.
Morning, honey.
What's the most you ever spent?
How about some coffee?
This is the bottom line of like women's.
I usually wear a pair of basketball shorts.
Yours is this one. I've got a fresh one. Oh, look at this. This is ridiculous. Look at this guy's hair. Are you serious?
I knocked my mic down.
What are you watching? I don't understand.
This is a game from what year, Mark?
Nah,
Dan, you gotta get a look at this.
Why about the guy that built this place?
Give him his mic. Give him the microphone.
Oh, hi, Spaz.
How you doing, huh?
This is my room.
Who lives here? This is, I don't know.
No.
This is the best.
What are you gonna do today, sweetheart?
Really?
Well, I don't know. I'm almost finished unpacking.
Well, then I'll put my mic on.
How about you?
You see that bathroom yet on the second floor?
You've been to good Brooklyn.
I like that. I think I'm going to turn it into a photo lab for myself.
Dan has done such a job in this living room with his decorations. And his
That's a good idea.
Everything he does.
What's in that box?
I'm going to put this between
us. Well, I don't know. I haven't gone through it yet.
Yeah, go, go, go.
Let's see.
Are you seeing this, Dan?
What? No, what is this freak show? Oh, wait. This is
MPEG. Oh, it's Christmas.
This is the guy.
This is like 32X.
Hop in this here.
Just a sec.
We're
going
to play Garfield card.
Yeah, play Garfield card. This game is horrible. Whoever chose this is a suck dog.
You remember this?
Suck dog is like a dog that sucks. You know?
Yeah.
Like it
stinks. Yeah, I gave you this for Halloween.
Stinky suck dog.
Rat? You know it was Christmas Eve. It was the night you proposed to me.
Are you sure I proposed to you?
We can share this
yes.
with
you.
Share this
with you. Of course I remember.
You know, yeah,
of
I
course
don't
I do.
Yes,
again.
I'd like to thank.
I bet.
This is my command. This is crazy. Look at this. I really gotta spend the night with this game, I feel like.
No, you don't.
It's a little small.
It's small on the screen. Oh, it's small. Yeah.
I can't possibly.
This looks like Mist with Freaks.
You gotta stop saying Freaks. It's gonna get you in trouble. Look, I'm opening a drawer.
How is Freak a problem?
Because I feel like, what was that shit? That was
but when
show?
You say the word Freak, it puts the onus on normality.
The
like,
onus on normality?
Yeah. Because it's saying, if I'm a Freak, if you're calling something a Freak, it's also kind of calling normality a freak.
But a freak can mean so many different things. you really confused Virgil. So no, what's going on anymore.
What?
So listen.
Virgil, what?
We're gonna play some Garfield Kart. We were gonna play Forza 3. And Forza 3, like Dan said, we fired it up earlier, and it actually bricked our software to stream. You put this on the floor, it's right here. It bricked our streaming software. Throw it down there. And now we decided we'll play the second best racing game that we have our hands on, which is Garfield Kart. My friend that I used to work with, Minami, recommended that I buy this game a long time ago.
Jeez, I don't think your mic is on.
Oh, isn't it?
It is. It's here.
No, it's muted. Wait.
Okay, so yeah. So my friend Minami recommended that I buy this game a while ago. I picked it up. It was $45.
Garfield Kart.
It was worth every penny. It was an absolutely phenomenal title.
Is it a new game?
Yes.
When you get lasagna, do you go faster?
Yes, you do, actually. You can pick up lasagna, and you go faster.
I love it already.
I'm just going to sync this controller up with the boat.
No.
If you want to get this is going to be a wild time.
What are you doing?
I'm syncing a controller with the boat, because we haven't done that.
Oh, you want me to start racing with me?
No, it's not all
good.
Got it. Done this.
Okay, so we're gonna go Garfield Kart. To go in Garfield Kart.
Game
one is a bit loud. Turn it down. Are you reading producer notes or are you saying that yourself?
I'm the person.
So here we go. And one of the most fun things about Garfield Kart is that you can't navigate it with a controller. You have to use a keyboard.
Are you serious?
How do we play with controllers?
Once you get in the race, you're fine.
Oh. So you have to navigate the menus with a keyboard.
Random. I don't. How do you play two-player in this? There's got to be a way. I'm not. Look, you go back with the pizza. Oh, look, two. Well, that's just what level you're on.
People are tuning in to watch this.
Where's my? Hold on.
I'm gonna be John.
Could you hand me one of those golden coins over there?
Oh, you swore.
Just one.
Does that work?
Yep.
Yeah.
In the pony shack, ladies and gentlemen.
Pony shack.
That's what it says, pony shack.
I thought you were making that up.
No, I didn't make it up. That's what it says.
Pony shack.
We're
out of here with
you. These are equestrian fans over here.
That's not mine.
I don't know how to do two players. I have to go back.
A lot of stuff in here is mine, but that's not. No, that froze. What are you guys doing?
The game just froze?
No, it didn't.
Mark, can you snuggle up to Jason a tad?
Get in here.
Sure, absolutely.
And can you just talk to me less?
We're low on intimacy here.
You don't want to talk? Really?
Which would be really great. Wait, inputs. Here we go. Player one.
How are you doing
and
over
then
there?
You just
player two.
Your finger and put it in
he's
his
pushing
ear.
Me. I've done nothing wrong.
Yeah, you freaks.
Artifact Studio.
Whoa.
I just have this.
Steady on.
Yeah, why do you have that?
This is for Martin.
Dan, do it.
This crystal ball is telling me that I'm safe, so put it down.
Okay.
Here we go. It looks like Garfield Kart might be a single-player experience, in which case we're just going to let you play.
No, but don't waste it.
was gonna throw it out.
He's got cheeseburgers.
We're going 50cc, random. Pizzas. And we're gonna go to Cats in the Hood.
That's the one we play. I wanna do that one.
And it's actually just single, and we're just gonna let you have a crack at this.
I read. It sounds substantiated.
You Saudi, have a crystal ball
Saudi
gazing
Saudi
book?
Yeah.
Where's our roaming camera?
Roaming candles?
Yeah, to make their decisions.
I do this. Do you notice how many I have in here? I have one.
If we could just
two,
get
three,
the book.
Four, five,
the book.
I'd say
six.
Limit.
I know. I know what.
Can you can you show him the book that you have?
I love you more.
Mama.
I do not endorse the views of the people in this room.
This is how you go.
I find these things
go.
Very...
Go.
You want this one?
Oh.
I think. Maybe you want this,
this
one.
This is one
player.
We're going to find out in a second when you press. Garfield cart is go.
This We're, game got a 10.
We need to figure out
what. 10 on
I?
What?
Who am I?
I chose John
in
for
the
you.
Mark Simon's game video
John.
Catalog.
That's the MSGVC.
She's got it.
And then
10.
What do I do to
MSGVC.
Move?
Just
oh.
left and right.
Oh. Oh.
And pull that trigger all
what
the way down.
This
Here we go.
Now.
Who's out?
Do I get these sweets?
Yeah.
Candy? Oh, God.
Oh,
female drivers.
Well, somebody said it.
Woo. Am I winning or am I at
you're
the
doing, You're not doing terrible, actually.
I
I'm really,
think you're doing great.
I'm really surprised.
Okay, I haven't played a game since I was... Oh, what happened to me?
The last thing she played was Grand Theft Auto.
Oh, my God, no, I don't want to do this.
And now we're moving on to Garfield Kart. I just want to ask if you
it's
people...
It's been about 20 years since I've played a game. Oh, sorry, I'll try and scream again.
Are you guys at home? Is this
oh,
what you signed
like
up for?
Huh?
When you heard there's going to be a boat party, did you think you'd be watching a bunch of the drunk people play Garfield Kart?
I'm not drunk.
I've been saying that Garfield Kart should have been played
but
the
wait.
Entire time.
Well, we'll do that on a future episode.
Like, no disrespect to Garfield Kart, but this has not really
me.
Moved on much from, like, Mario. Where's
no
the,
disrespect
like,
to Garfield Kart.
What's the USP of Garfield Kart?
What's the USP?
Unique selling point.
Oh, marketing terms.
It's Garfield characters.
Lasagna,
Odie.
Why
is that guy purple?
Superpowered. Odie. You know, there's a button you have to press to use power-ups, but...
He likes to take a nap.
I think we're gonna race straight.
Okay.
No power-ups. Try hitting A.
I'll stop
A. Wait, I'll hit it while you...
Lasagna,
oh, you got it.
Take a nap.
You
jump. Jump. Okay, what do I jump on?
Try hitting,
jump
hitting X.
X. Oh.
Oh, there it is. Use the pillow. It
What's
made everyone
good?
Go to sleep.
Whoa. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey! Yeah, of course
they This is very... You're
sweet dreams, suckers! Sorry.
You're actually in second place.
Now what do I do? Now what do I do?
Just get through it and then again.
Use the magic wand. Hit X
What's
again.
What's the magic wand? How?
I don't know. Use it.
Okay.
You have a magic wand.
I didn't even know
if you hit X, something will happen.
I don't remember a magic wand.
Oh, you
threw
it. Just
it.
Threw it.
Now
throw
freak.
It at somebody.
Oh, now you're going to go last.
Throw that wand at somebody.
How?
Just X again. Nice
yes.
shot. Holy
yes.
shit.
Wow.
Oh,
I missed the fast thing.
That's
you
actually
guys.
A cool item.
Flattering
diva.
Very good, very good.
Second,
oh,
yes,
wait
spring.
A minute. First.
No, use
I
that.
Yes!
Use
Here
that
we go.
Spring. Use the spring. Use the spring. Just use it.
I
don't know what the hell that was. Big
something.
Jump.
Oh, you missed everything.
It's okay. It's no big deal. She's
is it,
in
is
first.
It, is it
I don't need
I'm
those
actually
things.
Nervous.
I'm getting fired.
Oh,
I don't know what that
is.
Where
the fuck is a UFO?
You got aliens.
Sorry, where's my coins?
I'm now in
Thank you.
You were in first the whole way. Dan, your turn.
Guys, I gotta say, that really
stressed you out.
My adrenaline.
What in Garfield world are there UFOs?
Because they.
Just Dan, I think.
I don't want nothing to do with this.
Dan, I think you identify more with Garfield.
I don't
me too,
like
Mark,
it.
So go ahead.
You want me to play Garfield?
One more round. I'm gonna pick us a new map to keep the audience engaged.
All right, let's go.
I'm stressed out.
I'm waiting for a producer to just say, please, no more Garfield.
I watch Unsolved Mysteries a lot, so I know all about UFO stuff.
You can also swear.
It's gonna be fine.
Fuck.
Did I swear?
No, but you can, and then up
the pony shacks.
You can have some of my swear
money,
guys.
Balls.
Balls.
Virgil.
You're gonna laugh out of fucking. Denny.
Are you ready?
I'm ready. How do you move, eh?
I've been drinking
do you
six,
need this?
Seven beers. Yeah.
You've had six or seven beers?
The bartender's getting bombed.
Our bar.
Bandy. Bandy.
The bartender's in trouble. Let's go.
We're going to have to kill
what
all
is
this.
What is art?
That was a slow start, my friend.
Well, I'm sorry. I don't know how to play this.
We're in Egypt. The frame rates. All right, can I just?
I don't know how to play this thing.
Nobody knows how to play this. Yeah. Nobody knows how to play this.
Are you joking?
No, jump, A.
I'm gonna have to start this whole race over again.
A is a whole thing. You can jump.
He's going.
You're dumb, idiot.
I have to start over. That was so bad, Mark.
They don't have enough lasagna in Egypt for me. All right. All right, now right now I'm getting wild.
I'm getting a note from the producer that we should do an episode of speed running Garfield Kart.
I'm back.
Billy did not sign up for this ripple.
Billy Chris,
you got more lasagna than I, obviously. Hold on a second.
You're doing a good job.
Whoa, look at this.
Yeah. So hold on.
Drunk driving.
You're all over the place.
Credit goes to Belmo-san.
Belmo-san's dropping. Drop and come.
Whoa! Hi, Dad! I'm on TV!
I'm making it happen at 6, guys.
Audio is
here we go.
Oh, my audio is scratchy.
It's his luscious lock.
Oh, my hair is rubbing my microphone.
I know, you know.
Wait, I'm going to pull it back.
Let's get a Steven Seagal look on.
Okay.
That's what we're going
to
do right now.
Don't go stuck in there again.
I know.
Oh, you're stuck over there again.
Can you please use your perfume and make something happen?
What the hell are you talking about?
Now you're fast as hell and beautiful.
I think Joe might be a better driver.
Well, I don't think you're off on that aspect. Here we go. Now things are happening.
Virgil cooked you up a fresh one.
Thanks, bud.
Virgil, can I get another of my...
All right, here we go. Look at this. I got the spring.
Plenty of ice.
This is
Mogisaurus.
Mogisaurus.
Wow, you're getting called out. This is painful.
Yeah, this is painful, Mark.
Do you think I give a shit? Do
you swear to God?
I hope you would. This is the premiere episode of Boat Party.
And guess what? If we were a premiere episode and I was playing Mario Kart, it would be just as bad.
Yeah, well,
are you bad at Mario Kart too?
Yeah.
I think
and Sonic Racing.
You are bad. The most consistent, like, theme of the chat has been your
You
really? My locks?
Yeah, maybe it needs to be like a whole thing.
Maybe we should just do a live
Jason's
stream
hair
called
live
Jason's
stream.
Locks live stream. I'll speed run my hair. What place did you get there, buddy?
I finished.
Yeah, you finished.
Mark, you're right.
Guys, we have 20 minutes left.
Oh, no.
Mark, you can do it.
This went really fast. You
we
weren't kidding.
Minutes, we have 20 minutes left.
So can I just say
Focus,
that,
Mark.
Let me just say, for about a week now, I've been worried that 2 hours was way too much content. And this went by... really quick.
Felt like an eternity to me.
This is really like content.
It's because you've been dealing. It's because you've been dealing with fools.
It's not content. Live stream is just content.
Live stream content is nonsense.
Yeah.
That's the best part.
Joe
of it.
Thinks I'm flirting with you.
Oh, Joe Lavallo, stop flirting. I think he's talking about Dan.
Oh, okay.
Excuse me. Look at Garfield. He's driving within the lines. That's okay.
That's better than you did. But
right. Shit, maybe
close
not
this
there.
Game.
Okay.
Close this game.
So, we've done, let's take a look. We've done Doom. Now it's time for Dan to show us, before we leave.
What kind of games are these? Genital jousting? What is this? Knight?
Yeah, Dan.
Genital jousting.
Why don't you want to play genital jousting, Dan?
Dandy.
Because I think it's ugly.
It's your name.
I think it's a really ugly game.
Continue.
It's just ugly, and I think it's unfunny. And I think that it's kind of like, we talked about Freddy Got Fingered earlier. I think it's one of those games that maybe in 10 years will be funny, but right now I don't think it is. I don't think now is the time for genital jousting.
Dan's
when
not...
is the time?
When is the time for genital jousting, Dan?
Roman
time.
I don't know. I take a little offense at it, because you said one of my favorite movies is Freddy Got Fingered. You said that to me.
Yeah, but it's actually one of mine. And that...
No gentle jousting.
Yeah.
Can we just,
if
Dan, would you like to do a little My Way or the Highway?
Yeah, maybe we're going to cut to a segment.
Oh, you want
to
do Limp Bizkit?
How about this producer note that actually Twitch has blocked gentle jousting? You can't play that on Twitch.
Well, Dan and I are mayor of Steam. You see that? Drain puppet.
Well, you know,
never mind. Apparently, we can't. Okay,
Dan,
so let's throw. I wanted to give a little love to this game. It's called Flying Tigers.
Yeah.
And this game is made. It's an early access. From what I understand, it's not by a major studio. It's early.
Yeah, I want to show you guys. I want to show you guys how I like to play games, which is completely against. Well, I'm just going to show you guys how I like to play games.
Why don't we ask?
Nice. You want to play Double Dragon, don't you?
We don't want them to tell us.
I'm going to play this.
So, Dan likes to do things his way.
Well, I like to play his games way. when I'm in my own private. And so I like to.
You right over there?
Yeah. Here's the thing. I think that games create an incredible canvas for unbelievable behavior. And if you follow the path of what you're supposed to do, you'll end up where you're supposed to end up.
Right.
But what I like to do with a game is I like to just sort of use the machine. Yeah.
This is a segment we'll be doing from now on, and this is called My Way or the Highway, starring Dan. Yeah. And every episode.
My Way or the Highway. And what I do is I like to get into it, and I pick a cool airplane. Yeah.
Makes us look
and
very
attractive. I had this one. I had the Soviet airplane, and then yeah, I don't. And this is bad.
Like, where's the
and then I'm gonna go to Himalayas.
Well, then you might like this game very much.
Yeah. So we're gonna do a clear day.
No, it just has a whole other
Hey Dan, lean back in your chair.
Okay.
You might feel
and then,
at home.
So what I like to do though is I like to when they when they want you to play a certain way, I like to just go into a peaceful place where I spin around and look at things differently.
They want you to lean a bit forward. That's a lot forward.
They're telling us to do everything.
That's a bit forward. So here's Dan playing Flying Tigers, which is a great game. I really like it a lot. This is a good game.
I'm supposed to kill these people, right?
I got this in a bundle.
Like, I'm supposed to, you know, what they want me to do is they want me to shoot this person.
You're not gonna party with us? We have to celebrate our first episode. To what? We don't say it out loud. You don't want Twitch people to know where I never want a Twitch person to know where I am.
So what I like to do is
we're gonna get in the helicopter.
That's what I've been waiting for. Oh look,
so what I'll do is I'll find something upsetting in the game. Like this. where you just can make it upset you. And then and I just do it for a long time. I fly straight into space.
So you're supposed to play the game.
Yeah, but then I just slow it down and I just make it. I see the space. And I hold down the buttons.
This is incredible. You're breaking through.
Yeah, exactly.
Dan is turning games into art.
Yeah.
And he going to space?
My way or the highway?
Yeah, just shooting into space.
Dan's way.
Yeah, but can you go into space?
I don't know. I'm running out of weapons. No, but they just don't understand that what I'm doing right now, fucking Liechtenstein's could show.
Can we get
cigarettes?
Look how slobbish this is.
What did I do wrong? I'm enjoying myself here. I like space, I like shifts, I like shooting.
So now I'm shooting empty.
This is amazing. Sit down.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Just listen.
Yeah.
And then,
yeah, I'm out of ammo.
Jesus! Got more there, bud.
Just look at it. I wanna do this. Why do you wanna do this?
Just let it happen.
What's this segment, guys?
This is my way or the highway. This is where Dan plays games the way he likes to play them, and we're all forced to endure it.
Because we can't get on airplanes and see the world,
Mommy
he's showing them to us.
He's showing us artwork.
Dan, let's go.
I've never seen those now.
This guy, what the f is going on with this game?
It's amazing. I think it's poetry. It's poetry. He's gone off piece.
Seriously.
It's blacking out the whole screen.
This guy says Dan is hammered on life.
You can thank Timothy Leary for that one.
My Way or the Highway with Dan Meyer.
Yeah,
segment one.
Try to play it my way.
We're down to 12 minutes.
You just smash everything.
Yeah, in 12 minutes, he showed us so much of the world.
Where are you going?
I don't know. I've just been having my own time.
Right, have fun. Just do what you want.
I don't know.
You might want to go not at the ground, though.
I don't know.
It's your world.
I was just in my own zone.
No, I'm cheating.
I feel like she's doing a little My Way or the Highway.
Yeah, well, I taught them
my
how to
way
do it.
Or the highway.
That's a good voice, Mark.
Yeah.
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 Remember that hot track? We got some real shit.
You're supposed
real
to be shooting these people.
Here, guys.
This guy wants to know if, Dan, you can skim the ground for 5 seconds in this game to prove that you can play.
I don't know how to play.
Yeah, but you can skim.
I try to skim the ground.
Skim the ground.
Go
Get
down.
As close to the ground as you can.
This
is up and down.
These and down.
All you got to worry about is this button. No, wrong one.
Oh, look at that. It's cool.
Ooh, that's beautiful.
You know what? You really know how to just capture a picture. There's one right there.
Yeah.
Shooting. Shoot a little more. Not at us.
This is really.
Not at us.
My Way of the Highway is. This is a beautiful segment.
Isn't it?
It's just playing a game for the sheer joy of being in it.
Just being
art.
Free.
Oh.
This is off.
You're making art right now. Should we turn all the music off and just have the sound effects?
Woo.
Woo.
Charlotte's discovered a new button.
Woo!
For the
Sorry.
First time. In Twitch gaming, we are absolutely free.
What did I do?
Wow. Here we go. We're going to the moon.
We're going out of the bang. Dan, skim the ground for 5 seconds. Show them that you know what you're doing. Get down there.
Go for it.
Ah!
Oh, okay.
Here we go, guys.
Art.
Oh, I'm so stressed.
You want me to have that?
One.
Ah, yeah.
Oh. Two.
You, my friend.
I smashed it.
He smashed it quite literally.
He couldn't pull up just in time, could he?
This guy, oh man, Virgil's greasing Mark up.
What?
This guy's comment, Virgil's greasing Mark up.
I'll show you guys how to skin it.
Moving him up.
And before you hit the ground, you go, ah!
Now, wait a minute. Now, we've hit a point now where the stream is actually getting close to an end, and I wanted to ask the Twitch community now that we're at the end. First of all, we need to pick our Twitch user of the week. So who was being the most interesting in this chat?
Default Prophet.
Default Prophet was crushing
Default
it.
Default Prophet is the Twitch user.
Default Prophet, we've decided that you are the Twitch user of the week.
Not.
The real Dan Meyer is the worst Twitch user of the week.
Yeah.
Best Twitch user, Default
You're
Prophet.
Pretty good in my
and
eyes.
Default Prophet, we're going to sign the piece of the boat that we cut off, and we're going to send it to you, provided that you pay shipping and handling and all associated fees, because we're not going to pony up for that.
Yeah.
So we're going to need you to Venmo us some money. And once we get that cash, we'll
Dad
send you a piece of the boat.
Drunk,
how much is that going to be?
I mean,
I'm drunk?
30, 40 bucks.
I was born drunk.
So $30 or $40, you got your piece of the boat. Twitch user of the week.
It's a good deal.
Chopsticks by any chance. I know who that is. It's a really annoying person. I've been avoiding them for a really long time.
Oh, now you just called them out.
They found me.
They found you.
Jason, fire.
Producer's saying we got to count the loot in the swear jar. How do we do tonight, guys? So we're going to be donating this.
How many
sir,
gold
get in
coins
here.
Are in there?
Sir, get in there. And
this isn't right. People are stealing
we,
my money. My money has been
Just
stolen
FYI.
All night.
We have a bottle cap in there. That's worth nothing. Who threw that in there?
Not
Dan.
Me.
Maybe it was me.
Not me.
You threw a bottle cap in the swear jar?
Let me defend myself.
Mark.
I don't understand this. This American money.
How
this one means more money than this one, and it's just...
Oh,
this
come on. You've been living in America for
2 years.
2 years?
6 months.
Yeah, bull
You've only been
crap.
In America for 6 months?
Yes.
Yeah, but you've lived in America for 2 years.
So that's why this
okay.
is about
So,
worth
we have $1 for charity, $2 for charity, $3 for charity, $4 for charity, $5, $6, these are all Mark money, $7, $8 for charity. So you have $8 and $8.66. Someone's getting it.
We have $866 for everybody out there.
We're gonna be donating
what
this.
Charity? We should ask.
Yeah, Twitch, what charity do you feel like do you feel like we should be donating this to? You let us know. This guy says donate the swear jar to Virgil.
He already has plenty of money.
Virgil is fat with cash. He's fine. He doesn't need any money. Joe Lovallo says it's for the kids.
Jason, let me load up Thumper.
Oh, a quick Thumper to send us off.
Thumper from that cartoon.
Are you talking about? Are you talking about the Bambi?
Yeah. Let's do it.
You might like.
I feel like this is. I feel like we should just give Mark his own show.
It's kind of like the Black Beatles.
I mean, you give all the money to me. I deserve it.
You're not getting paid for this, well, by
this
the way.
There's a pig over there. Look at this. Look at, look around the room here. You got everything here. There's a pig there with a...
it's a...
what?
Something. There's
what's
a horse
the,
that has a...
Jason,
a,
turn it up.
A horse that has a goddamn...
Thumper is probably the most interesting game we've had in a very long time.
This is very good, this game. This is awesome. I can't comment on anything about this game because I'm so bad at it and everybody else
looks
is so
great.
Good.
Yeah.
It's really incredible. This guy says start a Guy Fieri fund.
It has a really nice soundtrack.
All right, Dan, show us how it's done. I've just been holding my body mic in my hand.
Why not?
It's really amazing. This is the best rhythm game that I've played in years, maybe ever actually, because it's the first rhythm game, and I remember playing one of the ones that actually really hit on the music properly. Was
hey, Jason,
a game called...
You should play this one because
sure.
You're good at this.
Let me just stick this back on me. We only got a few minutes left, but I want to talk really quickly about, it's a game called Mad Maestro, and that game was the first rhythm game that I remember that perfectly hit on every note, because Parappa the Rapper was an absolute disaster.
Parappa the Rapper had great graphics.
Parappa had interesting graphics, interesting style, but the gameplay itself was so sloppy and everything was so delayed, and it was really obnoxious. I hated playing Parappa the Rapper. It just never was
all right,
tight.
Just play this game.
I don't think
but
the music,
Mad, no, that wasn't it. Mad Maestro, that game, nobody knew about that game. There was another game called, before this that I played, it was called Guitaru Man.
He's talking too much.
That was a PS2 game. That really nailed it also. And
this game's very cool.
That was 15
yeah.
years ago.
Why do you put that going on?
That's because Dan's in level one.
It's a rhythm-based game.
Nothing
it's
happens
kind of like
in level one.
Like
Rockstar.
Rock
yeah,
Guitar
Hero.
They're
but
just teaching
doing,
me.
He's doing so well that you can't even tell that it's a rhythm game.
Tired Mark. Yeah.
I thought this was the intro.
It is the intro.
No.
It is. It's teaching you how to play.
This is like that film, Into the Abyss.
It is. It is. I'm sure that what's his name? What's that guy's name?
Who, the guy who made this game?
No, the guy made Into the Abyss and
the guy who what?
The guy made Into the Abyss.
Wait, you didn't actually declare
a charity
thing of the week?
No, oh, Twitch user of the week was what? What's that guy's default profit?
Default profit, or is it Twitch user of the week?
Default profit's Twitch user of the week. We had a really good time with Default Profit this week, and I feel like he earned his piece of the boat.
Yes.
Or her piece.
Yeah.
And you've been to boat parties.
I have. My dad
works. Your dad has a speedboat.
What?
Had a speedboat.
What does he do with a speedboat?
No, well,
raced
very,
it.
Very
what was the name of your dad's speedboat?
Good heavens, that's Madame Champagne. Far too good to waste on launching a ship.
Why is that the name of the boat?
Because
the
when
boat
you name a boat, if I had a boat in my lap, I'd show everybody. You get the bottle of Lady Aaron is the lady who names boats. She smashes the bottle of champagne on the hull and says, I name this vessel. And she went to do that to my dad's boat. And she as she swung the bottle of champagne towards the hull, she noticed it was Mum Champagne, Premier Cru.
It was good champagne.
And she said, I name this vessel. Good heavens, that's Mum Champagne. Far too good to waste on launching a boat.
And that.
And so they printed that along the side of the boat. That was the official name of the boat, but they called it Good Heavens before.
Good Heavens.
I'm sorry if that anecdote was far
the good. The Good Heavens.
Lost on everybody.
It's a great. It's a great story.
But anyway,
this game is so. This is kind of like the doom of rhythm games.
The doom of rhythm.
It's so violent and like viscerally pleasing and like guttural. It just feels
guttural.
Like
it makes you want to
it's
piss.
In your gut. You feel
it makes
nice.
Makes you want to piss is what you're saying.
It makes you want to piss. Is that, are you projecting?
You're like a piss freak.
I think it'll
a
be
a piss freak?
I think it'll be wonderful and interesting at the end of the series. We do like a rhythm game like this because I have.
There will never be an end of the series.
I mean per episode.
Yeah.
Because I have my Nintendo running pad and like.
Oh, you have the running pad.
Yeah.
So listen, our next show is going to be on March 5th. Is that
right, guys?
Episode?
We're going to be streaming every other Sunday, starting today.
This is it. This is your place to be on Sunday nights from now on.
And
Game of Thrones
I
is garbage.
Be here.
We'll get
Charlotte,
you back.
Charlotte won't be here again
Mark
next
will definitely
week.
Not be here again.
Mark's probably never going to be here again because he's going to die face
sorry,
down
guys.
In a gutter with a with fucking something in his mouth.
We didn't get to talk about
and
a lot of things I want to talk
what
about.
Time?
We're
going
to
yeah,
talk
about
I'll be
right.
down there in the
every Sunday from every
shit.
Other Sunday from now on at 7 o'clock Eastern at Twitch Waypoint.
Twitch.tv/Waypoint.
And
in the meantime,
we're gonna have Shur, we're gonna have Turtle, we're gonna have Denny, we're gonna have Virgil, we're gonna have Jason, we're gonna have me. Sometimes it'll be Charlotte, sometimes it'll be Mark.
I'll practice computer games so I'm less of a rookie.
Everyone's gonna start
we'll
practicing computer
Thanks.
Games. If you wanna be on the show, let us know. If you wanna
if Tim Allen's out there.
If Tim Allen's out there, we want you on here.
We wanna get you in.
That's your Nintendo game.
If you like websites, you can log into them. It's pretty easy.
Log into websites.
And if you want to have all kinds of different things to do, you can
check
you
out
can,
Waypoint in
you
general.
You can do that, but this is one of them.
This is the way, place to be on Sunday nights.
And Austin Walker, I love you. You're a good boy. And you've been leading the charge for a long time.
Yeah, Austin, and thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to, you know, get
we've
out
We've been
here
ashing in my grandmother's pig tureen
also,
the whole night.
The whole reason that
oh, shit, you didn't say that. I would have done
people.
That if I knew.
Yeah,
and we
true.
Wouldn't be doing this, guys. We wouldn't be doing this without the Waypoint
Twitch
fans.
Was, you guys called out enough, and you guys wouldn't shut up about Bo Party enough to and the Waypoint streams that they finally gave us a platform. And so thank you for Twitch. You guys are really... We're so thankful for Twitch in general.
Yeah.
Because this is, we're having a really good time and this is a really fun show and we want to keep doing this for you. So keep tuning into the
and
show.
We couldn't do it without, like, Danica.
We can't do that. Who's Danica?
Who's Danica?
Oh, Danica's
Dan! That's messed up. She's in the other room.
I'm very bad
Patrick.
At names.
Who's Patrick?
Danica Patrick is, I think.
Oh, the race car driver.
Yeah, she's.
She was a good character in Sonic All-Stars All right. Racing.
Hey, sure. Turn around and get a picture of the boat.
Let's get the boat before we go. We're going to saw this bitch up and we're going to put it
hey.
On video. Oh, here we go.
Don't use that word.
If you, and by the way, if we keep swaying, we're going to throw it in the pony shack.
we know.
All right.
Yeah.
And Virgil.
Virgil.
Yeah.
Oh, Virgil.
Yes,
thank you, Virgil.
Yeah.
That's all. Come on, Virgil.
Virgil lubricates.
Love Virgil.
Virgil, thank
Absolutely.
You very much. Appreciate you being
my
here.
Man, I especially like Virgil. Here you go,
so, guys, what's the
my
next
body.
Episode?
The next episode is actually, we're going to be playing the Nintendo
be,
Switch.
Well, the next episode is going to be the future of gaming.
No, it's going overboard. Going overboard is going out of our out of our zone of comfort and playing things that are not related to the boat, which means that we're going to have a Nintendo Switch here, and we're going to give a first look only, what, 2 days after it comes out? Because March 5th, it comes out the 3rd. We're going to get a Switch here. Austin, by the way, I'm just going to let you know that we need a Switch on the 5th. So if you can get that to us, it'd be great.
And
so
Neo
we're gonna,
Geo, maybe.
Neo Geo. We're going to be playing a Nintendo Switch. We're going to test out a lot of the games, whatever we can get our hands on. Hopefully we have one at that time, and we're going to have, you know, different guests, completely different content, because we'll figure out how to make the little box work that streams things, and it'll be nicer. This is a little ghetto, but it worked.
Thanks for having me. Thank you for tolerating me.
Cheers, everyone.
All right, cheers, everyone. The boat party.
The boat party was a success. Mark, thanks for coming.
On the first episode. Thanks for coming. Thank you very much. And thank you, bartender, because you and I, my man. Right. So thank you.
Cheers. Thanks everybody right. for tuning in. I appreciate it.
Had a wonderful
it.
Time.
Love you guys. Love you too.
Is this one like it's a news thing and like they show us hanging out after the sound goes off?
I go, huh. So many reasons. Those are the guys.